This is a public service announcement from Trick or Treat Radio.
Nick 2D2?
Hey.
Nick 2D2? Hey, you found a cigarette.
All the kids are doing it.
Well, I don't think smoking is grown up at all.
Yeah, well, all the different Albanian droids are smoking their goddamn sackets off.
Well, I know I don't have one, but humans do. And I think we should set a good example.
What are you talking about, you crazy old Jew?
Drop the fucking cigarette, you moron.
All right, I'm going to go listen to a little Caress to the Knave.
Well done, Nick2D2. Hey there. I'm Larry Fine of the Three Stooges, and I just want you to know that smoking isn't growing up at all. So please, don't smoke.
Smoking's for pussies.
Smoking is for pussies, you moron.
Welcome to Trick or Treat Radio.
Welcome to episode 60. What the fuck was that? We're doing the intro again, folks. Man, that was awesome. Welcome. I had this big fucking intro all planned out for episode 69, and it got fucked up.
69.
Jesus. Welcome to episode 69. 69.
Oh yeah!
Oh, man. You know what, guys? This is the only time we're ever going to have episode 69.
And no matter what happens tonight, it's going to leave a bad taste in your mouth.
What is he doing here?
Or a crick in your back.
Well, remember when we said last week that somebody's going to win a contest?
No. We said that?
Yeah.
Yes, you did.
I remember.
Unfortunately, your podcast is so cheap that the only prize you offer is to sit in a poorly lit room for 4 hours. So here I am.
What does that say about you?
You know, I brought gifts this week.
Oh, okay.
The mech is back.
Much like, what'd you say?
The mech is back.
Let's go, no. Snack cakes.
Bought something else, but as soon as Raven Shadow gets here, I'll bring him out.
All right, let me get to this intro, and we'll talk more about why this gentleman is in studio. So this is episode 69 of Trick or Treat Radio. Trick or Treat Radio is a phantasmagorical spin kick straight through the heart of pop culture. It is navigated by the Deadites. The Deadites are the world's greatest band, electroshock band, that is. We destroy monsters, we drink booze, we win championship belts, and we've been known to drive women into masturbatory bliss during our live shows.
Namely, Sir Isaac's mom.
Not Prince! You had to play that. You had to fucking play that. I'll listen to that. I spent 20 minutes dry heaving in the toilet. Thanks for nothing.
Hey, we...
You're lucky I didn't bring a gun in.
Whoa. Why isn't Tiny White here? Tiny, I wish you were here with your katana just to guard this son of a bitch.
Your other prize could have been 69 with Rufus and Ronaldo.
That's true. It is episode 69.
It's not too late.
Actually, with Rufus and Ronaldo, that'd be a 138.
It would be like getting suffocated by flubber.
I don't know if I'm more astounded by the fact that he knows how to add 69 than 69, or the fact that Isaac's in studio. I don't know. All right. Well.
I'm going to go for A.
Yeah, the math, definitely.
I've been here before. Come on.
We also, by the way, we also are a clearly acclaimed international peacekeeping podcast.
Obviously.
Very clearly, yes.
Yeah. We're just so cool, can't you tell?
And on this evening's show, we're going to review the film Man of Tai Chi, directed by Keanu Reeves.
Whoa. Directed by
Joey Lawrence. Yeah.
At this point, I would have given it a shot.
And we'll also have, I think we'll have a double tap tonight. I think we'll have time. We don't have too much going on. No interviews is scheduled for this evening. So
no.
All right, let me introduce everyone on the show. I am Johnny Wolfenstein. I'm the pencil pusher and producer of media for Trick or Treat Radio and for the Deadites. I have 3.5 confirmed monster kills. We also have the immortal gunslinger, singer, and lyricist for the Deadites. He has 972 confirmed monster kills. Dynamo Mars.
What's up, y'all?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Mr. Quiet's outside the studio right now. Obviously bagging old ladies' groceries or something. I'm not pausing what he's doing out there.
We also have the katana-wielding, synth-collecting, mask-wearing composer and songwriter for the Deadites. He has 1,011 confirmed monster kills, Mr.
That's
Tiny
more. Yep. That's more than the other one.
Mm-hmm. Than the other one.
Yep, that's more than the other one.
The other one, the other one me or the other last week?
Yeah, both, no, more I guess. Than you, more yeah. than the other one. You're the other one.
It's true.
Don't you know that?
Mm-hmm. We also have the chain-smoking, hand-kissing, baby-shaking, hot-pocket-loving...
Just going into the studio.
...comic book-reading nerd. He has 3 unconfirmed monster kills. Michael, woo! 5 to the sky, Raven Shadow.
Woo! What's going on, everybody? How we doing?
Oh, my God. Pretty good. Yeah. Pretty good.
You know, that was fucking seamless. That was
triggered by a Twitter conversation I had with Pantophobe and something that somebody has never listened to the show said to me. I think we should add, in addition to all of air quotes, Michael Raven Shadow's accolades
yep.
and skills,
yep.
We should add actually what he does in the band, because the feedback I got from 2 different people is, so what the fuck does that guy do? he's like, that one guy reviews movies and swears. Some other guy turns the knobs. You 2 are in the Deadites. What's that fucking guy do? So we should add.
Well,
know,
what do you do?
I diversify.
Yeah, perfect.
I'm the X Factor.
You're the X Factor is drawn by Rob Liefeld.
Ooh, he never drew Rob X Factor, sir.
What did X
He's the official smoke machine for the Deadites.
Yes, yes. I'm going home, fuck you.
Oh, that's amazing.
That's why he's there.
Yeah, baby, get back here.
I know he's not really leaving because he left a $3 case of beer behind.
Remember, the next time you guys do a show, you don't need that goddamn smoke machine. You could just have him smoke, blow smoke in the background.
Blow smoke out of his eyes. Kenneth Keith Kallenbach style. Yeah.
I watched a video of that. He starts puking up all over the place.
Oh, he came back. He came back, folks.
By the way, you're someone called us outside of the crypt the other day. They said last time Raven Shadow went out to smoke, it looked like the Hounds of the Baskervilles outside.
All right, let's get through the rest of this. We also have the vulgar guru of horror, the star of Blood Pigs and Fetus, and contributor for Horror Hound magazine. He has 1 million dead baby kills, Monster Fucking Zero.
Hello, everybody. Will you be my friend?
No.
Well, then fuck all y'all.
If we're not your friends,
yeah. they're
surely not going to be your fucking friends.
My name is Ivan Koloff. I held the world title belt for 16 days in 1974. I one time wrote for Horror Hound magazine.
What?
He's saying you're holding on to the past, man. These little
The past is all I got. I have no future. I have zero future. Look at what I do on my Wednesday nights for Christ's sake.
I was the fastest sperm.
And somehow you became the winning sperm. I don't know how the hell that happened.
It's like real life. I wasn't fast, but I just cut off all the other sperms at their ankles.
Did all the other sperm have like Down syndrome or something? I mean
Jesus Christ.
Speaking of that, I won't go into very much detail, but I believe when I was at my favorite gas station, Flynn's, the other day,
mm-hmm.
They were talking about a contest they were having to see who could do sex on the most mentally deficient people.
I'd like to do sex on you.
Now get out of your wheelchair.
Not physically deficient. Like, and one guy claimed that he already was. I'm just gonna say it. I'm too deep in the retards.
No.
Yeah.
No. He didn't say retards. He said like, I don't know. It was something like that though. It wasn't like slangy. It was like one of those outdated technical terms. You know, like they're not.
Botards, halftards.
No, it wasn't slow kids either.
Well, they should really check the
Mongoloids. I think it was Mongoloids.
Mongoloids.
I believe the phrase is going down syndrome.
Oh.
I think you should check Flynn's cerebral palsy on that in the back.
Hey, when my nuts turn numb, I have cerebral palsy.
Jesus Christ.
That's an actual name of a punk band.
Yeah. Does that mean
it's a good one too? I like them.
Does that mean when that happens, does Rufus and Ronaldo read backwards? Does that mean they have dyslexia?
Hey, I don't ever want to lose Rufus and Ronaldo, and if I ever do, I can actually play the cello again.
What?
A little music for your case. This is the Flynn song.
Is this cerebral palsy?
I get laid at Flynn's. I get laid at Flynn's. Happy as I can be. I get down at Flynn's. I get down at Flynn's with all the truck drivers going at me.
I got to jump to the chorus at least.
Good things nobody's listening.
I know. I have to get to the punchline.
You skipped it. Yep. Wow, you were entertained by that.
MonsterZero is a fucking Mongoloid.
It's a good thing. Yeah, if you go down to Flynn's, you'll get laid. I really couldn't believe it, though. And then I taught the lady behind the counter how to ring in my sandwich.
What?
She was like, "What's that?" And like she was standing behind a big like I'm like, "It's the tailgater. You're standing behind a
the
giant."
What?
Imagine. Oh no. Don't
wait.
Don't
why
make fun.
Are you eating a sandwich called a tailgater?
Imagine the breakfast version of the stadium burger. And that's what we're talking about.
Oh my god.
It is a sausage on English muffin with peppers and onions, barbecue sauce. Oh.
Should be called a Mongoloid.
It is delicious. But this fucking woman is like, "How you ring this in? I don't know how to ring in the special sandwiches." And I'm like, and because of my past and unfortunately retail, I was familiar with the what is called the Aloha system. So I was like, well, do you have a button that says special? And she's like, yeah. And he clicks on it. And
she's like, yeah, I wear it on my coat every day. Oh my god!
The blue plate on my car.
It's how I know what bus to get on.
It was the name of the. Oh, you said it.
It's like, so then she's like, "The gator sandwich. We don't have the gator sandwich here. The gator sandwich." I was like, "Just take a sausage and throw onions on it." Like, I have to go.
I have to hit this mic one of these days.
I could fucking stay here all day, but.
Oh my god! And then you made love to her, and the other guy high fived you.
No way.
I think.
There was a guy who's at Flynn's all the time who I think is a Deadites fan, and I think he was at the last show. I couldn't figure out how I knew him.
Don't say that.
But
I
walked in, and he like toasted me with a bottle of booze just now. Well, just right before now, when I bought this delicious Dunkin' Donuts with a raspberry-flavored shot in it. Extra, extra cream, 5 equal. Flavor shots at Dunkin' Donuts, a sugar-free, delicious treat.
What?
See, this is why he's not worried about diabetes. It doesn't matter if his toes turn black. His stomach's going to be so big he won't be able to see him.
All right, well, I've been avoiding the inevitable here, but
yeah,
we do have also in studio.
Oh, I got an intro.
No.
What?
We have, because he won a fucking bet.
This is your outro.
Yeah, we're done with you.
The British supervillain supreme, Sir Isaac.
Woo!
Thank you. Lovely to be here.
What are you clapping for?
Yeah, what the fuck?
Because he knows genius when he sees it. That's
right,
why.
That's right.
Why aren't you applauding?
Right here.
Wait, they're fucking giving
daps. Think about who's got your back here.
Daps.
Who's good? Who's back?
He's staying away from our back, so.
Yeah.
Ooh.
This is episode 69. I'm kind of glad to be out of the studio on episode 69.
Oh, yeah, and how's that different from any other night?
I can't stand the stink.
It's the contrast.
It's the contrast.
It's a tepid smell.
So, let's see. So, yeah, we talked about... Did I even mention? I didn't even fucking know. This show is off the rails already, dudes. But we're going to be talking... We're going to be talking about Keanu Reeves's directorial debut, the Chinese-American-speaking film Man of Tai Chi.
Whoa.
I know Tai Chi. Whoa. We'll be discussing that in a little bit. We will also have some voicemails and maybe some other feedback. We'll have our Twitter moment with Pantophobe, who is the only one that seems to tweet about us, which is pretty fucking awesome for them.
Very nice of her.
And
who
we will
neither
also
me and MonsterZero are allowed to talk to on Twitter anymore.
No, you're not. And because you're going to scare her away.
Another day, another restraining
order. I don't scare her away.
Yeah, you do. You scared her. I hurt her feelings.
And we'll also probably have time for a double tap later on, so... I have to start thinking of one because I have no fucking clue right now.
Well, you still got two or three hours left to intro to.
That's right.
Mull it over.
So that's what's going on for this episode. We have a supervillain in studio. Is he here all fucking show?
Yes, I am.
I'm not going to address him directly. I'm looking at you, Dynamo.
You're not going to address him directly?
No, not
right,
that
you're
either.
Not
gonna.
Dynamo, take his shirt off.
You know what? I would rather have that than be my most of my time direction be Raven Shadow in 9.
In nine or in 8?
You fucking chooch.
Yeah, I'm the chooch. I might speak it poorly, but at least I speak English.
Can you write it?
No.
Raven Shadow in 8.
Yeah. Bomboleo. Forget about it.
That's it?
Yeah, good work.
Jeez, man.
Well, it's early. I'm not going
to... Not going to blow your load?
Yeah, as you were.
Yeah.
Who runs that computer stuff? Whose fault is it that my pictures weren't showing up yesterday?
I don't know whose fault it was.
And that only hot ladies were seeing it.
Well, is that so bad?
Nope, it was perfect.
All right. We haven't got a straight answer. Why is he here?
Yeah. I'm trying to ignore him, and maybe he'll go away. It hasn't worked for 69 episodes with Raven Shadow, but
hey.
I'm hoping.
The reason why
is... Raiding Shadows, what is it?
Because of all the good marketing I did for your show, mm-hmm. You told your legal department to give me something nice. Mm-hmm. And this is the nicest thing they had.
Wow.
I really think you should look in the more legal counsel.
No way. My prize is the legal counsel.
We obviously can't afford it. We can't even afford the legal counsel that keeps villains out of the studio.
No.
My point exactly.
I think she just dislikes us. So, or you guys.
So can we kill him? Did she send you any...
You can try and you will fail. For I am awesome and you are not.
You're a supervillain.
Yes, I am.
And we're monster hunters.
So am I.
Wait. You kill humans. You turned them human and then killed them.
Yeah, I found a loophole that you lot have too stupid to realize.
Ricky Schroeder.
You're welcome.
Wait,
I have
a couple words for you. I don't know how many they are, so I can't tell you. But Ricky Schroeder's stepmom's vagina.
Hmm. Fuck that.
Yeah,
all right.
That's what I'm saying.
If
yeah.
you say so.
1984 call.
See, I know that you don't. You know, I know that people from your part of the world have questionable ethics, but. You have to understand that there's a code to monster hunting, and there's certain stuff that you can't do, and it's wrong. And Tiny, I hope you're writing down, turn them back to humans first.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I can't win with you bastards. I just can't.
Nope.
No, you can't. All right, so that's going to do it for that. Let's go to the Twitter minute with Pantophobe. Well, it's going to be more like 10 minutes. You guys have, like, pissed her off. What the fuck? Mm-mm. The only person that tweets about us, and you're pissing her off.
Not
well,
me.
You guys, those guys.
Yeah, I'm not talking to you.
Those guys. Yeah. What do you mean, guys? I'm not pissing her off.
You're right. I'm sorry, boy.
Yeah, he doesn't even know how to use Twitter.
I do know how to use Twitter.
Not you.
Oh.
So let me go back. She tweeted a lot about us. Let's see. First of all, she sent us a. I can't remember if this is. No. This wasn't last week. She sent a picture of her coolest VHS tape. She must have heard the Dan Kinnam show. I think it was 57. So she sent a picture. I don't know if you guys can see this right here.
Is that a porn?
What is that?
No, it's so she sent a picture of a pink Punky Brewster VHS.
Nice.
Holy shit.
It's her holding, it says Punky Power. So she sent us a picture of that. It's Punky Brewster, Punky Power, Volume 3.
Nice. Wow.
And it still has the video store sticker on it from somewhere in West Boylston, it looks like.
I just watched Pumpkinhead Blood Wings the other day, part
it's
of it.
It's not the same.
And I want a Soleil Moon Fry.
Remember the episode when Cherry went in the fridge?
Yes. Remember that? Yes, I remember that.
And there was a two-parter when they went camping.
Yep.
And there were demons. Remember that?
No.
What?
No.
No.
Did you ever see? Did you ever see the one where Punky befriends a really big fat girl, and everybody made fun of her because she was so big and fat, and next thing you know, she loses all the weight, and you could tell she's like wearing a fat suit, but yet her head was still skinny. Her face was still like skinny size.
No.
Yeah, it was pretty crazy.
That's really.
I'm sure Panafoe remembers it. It might even be on that on the videotape that she
could
has.
Could be on Volume 3. Yep.
Remember, children.
Yeah, let us know, Panafoe, if that's on there.
Jesus. And she also states she said the lecturer today, so she must have been in a lecture, told the audience to strap on.
Wow.
She
what?
Followed it with spiritual seatbelts, but still strap on.
Did she say Bambaleo after that?
That's exactly what we say anyway.
I know. Strap on spiritual seatbelts.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's maybe what I say.
What I'm saying.
So that's pretty cool. The lecturer must be a big fan of a big Wolfenite.
Hey.
Take all the glory for yourself.
I just got a new bidet made of Wolfenite.
I don't even want to think about you using a bidet, dude. That is just disturbing beyond belief.
Too late.
She also says another tweet. Oh man, I got to catch up with the Deadites podcast so I can watch them do it live. They get naked.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
No, oh. Psycho Patrick gets naked.
He's big. He counts for all of us.
Yeah, that's true. She also says, "Who's the fucking cherry tree motherfucker? George Washington? There you go. Raven Shadow is by far my favorite Deadite."
Oh shit. That's from the masses.
Wow. A wow, Wolf by
far. The masses of one.
Oh, my Lord. I'm like Daryl from Walking Dead. Not in the, not in the comic, but just a fan favorite.
Is that it? You're done?
Yeah.
So I guess if Raven Shadow dies, we riot, right?
Wait. She also says, first, before I get my ass handed to me, I know Raven Shadow isn't a Deadite. It's just easier to say on Twitter. Don't kill me.
How's that easier?
I accidentally killed her after this.
Yeah. And then she says, but seriously, I'm listening to the podcast where they thought I said Raven Shadow was a Deadite and almost rioted.
One guy did.
And then Dynamo, you said, why do you hate me? I don't have the whole entire conversation here, and I'm not going to go through the whole thing. No. But
I pretty much told her, you know, the only thing I said her straight on is no fire, no nudity, no riot.
Right, right. So,
wait, whose rules are those?
Huh? That's how I knew I – that's when you – and I quoted Miller's Crossing. When I raise hell, you'll know it.
She then she said, I should just stop tweeting. No.
No, no,
no.
No, little bird. Never stop tweeting.
You should you are a awesome lady with terrible taste in radio personalities, but very good taste in music.
And the final thing she says is, wait, I was supposed to help prove the masturbatory bliss claim. I thought there was a moratorium on the whole thing. I failed.
Just lifted.
Should we not mention that? Go on to next Twitter.
Let's talk about that.
Go on to the next Twitter.
You just don't want to mention it because the cobblestones outside your family estate are still wet. Somebody slipped and fell.
What was it? Bent knobs and broomsticks like a motherfucker.
Jesus Christ.
I can't wait till the diabetes makes you blind and impotent.
Chitty chitty bang bang. Dick Van Dyke.
Oh, man. All right. So we need to.
Thanks for nothing, Mom. Thanks for nothing.
We need to.
I should have destroyed your fucking phone before I left.
She's.
What?
They've renamed your steps Jack the Slipper.
Oh, my God.
Cut the commercial.
We're not ready for one yet. Oh, man.
Every time the door opens, you can just hear the theme to the old toy Slip and Slide coming out of there. Slip and Slide.
What does that sound like?
Slip and Slide.
I'm going to get you for this one.
You're the one that wanted to. This is your prize.
Do you like your prize?
This is your prize. You get to sit in the middle of four guys while we talk about your mother coming. That's great.
I think great.
And when was the last time we had any ladies in here again? Can't imagine why not.
It wasn't that long ago. Wait, we have audio from from your mom's.
The fuck you do? What have you done now?
That's a stroke.
I once heard it when I was a teenager. Trust me, I wish it sounded like that. Closer. needs a sucking sound now.
I've heard it sounds like ringing out a mop.
Oh.
So where can you find us, Johnny?
You can find us right on the internet.
Really? Yep. Okay, good.
That's the place to find us.
You better be careful. They'll be looking for you at Flynn's.
So, all right. Let's get to that part. We need to get on with the show. So, you can interact with the Deadites in a multitude of ways here. You can go to thedeadites.com. There you will find all sorts of shit for your face. Not real shit. You'll find audio. You'll find video. You'll find pictures. You'll find monster hunting tips from Tiny White about vampires and ice cream and all sorts of stuff. It's fun stuff. You also find us on YouTube. You may even be watching us right on at this very moment right there. But if you're not and you haven't already added us, go ahead and locate our channel. It's the Deadites TV. Go ahead and subscribe to us. Check out our videos. And on Facebook, facebook.com/thedeadites. On Twitter, @thedeadites. And the show you're listening to right now, Trick or Treat Radio, is available on iTunes, Stitcher Radio, and trickortreatradio.com. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe on iTunes if that's your platform of choice, and leave us a 5-star review. We'd appreciate that shit. And on trickortreatradio.com, if you'd like to interact with the show, you can go ahead and leave a voicemail right on the side of the website there on the right-hand side. Just click the button, leave a voicemail. A little dialog box will pop up, and you can go ahead and leave us a voicemail using the microphone on your computer. You could also send us an email, podcast@trickortreatradio.com. If you have one of those newfangled smartphones, you can go ahead and record a voice memo and just send it off that way. And lastly, the most important bit, according to Raven Shadow, so there's three things in life. What are they, Raven Shadow?
They are death, taxes, and trick-or-treat radio every Friday morning.
Right, those are the three things you can count on. And then, after the show ends, when you've done listening to us rant and rave for 3 hours, you know, what? If you haven't gotten your fix, what do you do?
You know what I'm going to do? It's November.
Oh, it's Movember.
It's Movember. And
Mo-Better the Blues.
Trick-or-treat radio fib group is kind of like a virtual Thanksgiving dinner. But you don't have to wait one day a year to get full. No, you can stuff yourself on our content 24/7. You know, 365, new 52, whatever it is, you really can just indulge. You know, we got giblets. We got virtual giblets. MonsterZeros. You know, the turkey. You know, Dynamo's a turnip. If you like my dinner table on Thanksgiving, I'll be the Italian sausage. We got all you need. You know what I mean? Like, there's so much.
I'll tell you what. You get home early, I'm likely to turn up in your bed.
You got bangers and mash over here. You know, fucking jump on, log on, and strap on.
We have a couple of great conversations going on in the Fib right now, including a really cool one about your favorite Stephen King film adaptation.
Ooh. Adaptation?
Yeah,
adaptation. The Mangler.
Yeah, we have a lot of talking about how smoking's for pussies.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Yeah. It is.
And we have... We have a awesome picture that privacy settings. Doesn't let anyone else on the board see except me, I don't think. But a longtime board member, I'm going to say his name wrong, Mike DeGaza, did the artwork for Sharknado 2, and it landed on the cover of Variety this week. So
it's pretty fantastic.
Yeah, so that's that thing where it said attachment unavailable. That's what that was. Sharknado.
Oh, that's why I couldn't see it.
Sharknado dose. But I didn't feel right about just stealing his picture that he took himself, so I figured I would try to share the link. But since he don't really like any of you guys, you can't see it. I'm sorry if I said your name wrong, Michael. Die Gaza?
I don't know.
Kind of sounds like a fighting robot. Die guys, go!
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
That's kind of awesome.
Meanwhile, that guy's getting paid. Gaza. Yeah.
Speaking of robots, where's the mech?
Who's the last one that saw it?
You.
Was it me?
You.
Sorry, well, Isaac, you didn't go down and retrieve it?
Well, how would I do that?
Retrieve? What? Oh, yeah. Who, Isaac?
Yeah, I thought maybe.
You may as well. You know how to freaking drive the thing.
Yeah. Not
apparently
many people
better
do.
Than I do.
It was never proven that I stole that.
Didn't you admit to it?
No.
There's a difference between admitting to
it. It was suggested by the INS that I did so, but they never proved it. Also, the person in charge died tragically.
Interesting.
Self-inflicted gunshot to the head 3 times.
I'll just say it. I'll say it the right way so it won't sound quite as homosexy. But Mike DeGaza is my Christmas Valentine. No, I said it wrong. Mike DeGaza is my Christmas Valentine this year. Fine,
Your
I said it.
Christmas Valentine.
Yeah, it was much more sexy when it was Tani last year, Coop's roommate. This year it's a dude.
Okay.
But it's okay.
I have to look up Mike DeGrazia.
DeGrazia? DeGrazia? Yeah.
DeGrazia Junior High.
That's what it looks like to me. So,
wake up in the morning feeling bright and early. I got to go to school.
All right. So we need to...
get the fuck on.
Yeah, we need to get to this. So let me play something here. This will get us ready for the review.
Whoa.
All right. That means it's time for everyone to strap on your spiritual seatbelts. And let's get ready to suck it. Woo! Raven Child, your favorite part of the show.
That's
lead us
suck it.
Lead us in the break.
Suck it.
Come on, lead us in the break.
I love you, Xbox.
Let's get ready to suck it.
Oh my god. All right, let's go to break. Cut the commercial.
Do you love a scary story?
Do you love scary stories?
I do.
Do you love to dance?
The big scary monster haunts at midnight is a collection of dark songs about sex, love, death, revenge, and the end of the world. Brought to you by the world's greatest monster haunting electroshock band, the Deadites.
If you ever consider getting into it, so I added everything that I'm going to do.
Hey there, this is R.A. Salvatore, call me Bob, and you're listening to Trick or Treat Radio.
What's up, y'all? It's me, the Yeti, telling all the ladies that they couldn't be more fine and that we should knock down
some slack Frankenstein.
When I want to get my nerd on, I go to Facebook and I go to the Trick or Treat Radio Facebook group. That's the place where I get to talk about all the hip new horror movies, all
the TV I had at Target on sale, and in all regions.
RPGs, video games, you name it. We're talking about shit on there. You could not be any cooler if you were the coolest kid in school. Be the first kid on your block. to swing that cock over at the Trick or Treat Radio Facebook group. Just go to Facebook, search for Trick or Treat Radio, ask to join, and it's like Nerd Nirvana, baby, without the shotgun blast. This is the Yeti, signing out.
Oh shit, that's why I don't
Trick or Treat Radio Facebook group.
I'm...
Follow us on Twitter, at the Deadites, thedeadites.com, and trickortreatradio.com.
Remind me before next Wednesday.
You betrayed by the light. You turn the daggers in your back to fashion, slipping made wrong right. Standing on the shore.
And we are back from break. Sorry, Raven Shadow, we had to end sooner or later.
What the fuck?
Go back.
Like the
go back. He wants to go back to break?
Yeah. I want to go back to break.
Wait, did Raven Shadow even smoke a cigarette during that break?
No, no, sorry, let's go again. Yeah. All right, let's do it. Let's get a mulligan.
Nope, nope, too late, too late. So.
Stupid break.
Stupid break?
That was a dumb break.
Oh, yeah, stupid break.
That's awesome. I didn't know that that was in your repertoire.
Raven Shadow.
I've always
stupid break.
I've always said that when you were shaved, that you looked like Homer Simpson, like in a beard disguise.
All right.
Oh, boy.
Well, we have a movie to review, guys. Mm-hmm. We are going to review The Man of Tai Chi from 2013. This is a action film, a kung fu action film, 105 minutes, rated R. It was directed by Keanu Reeves, written by Michael G. Cooney, and it stars Keanu Reeves, Tiger Chen. What? What is? What are you laughing at?
I'm just laughing because you said it, Michael J. Cooney, and all. Oh, when you say shit. Cooney, all I think about is UHF.
Okay, I thought you were going to say something else.
Yeah,
all right.
Jesus yeah. Christ. No, what was...
And also Karen Mok, who supposedly is a pretty big star in China, and she's pretty, pretty freaking sexy.
Mm-hmm. Foxy, Foxy.
Yeah, brr, brr, brr.
Foxy, Foxy for Shawa. So, Man of Tai Chi, it's the directorial debut of Keanu Reeves. Whoa. The synopsis we have here is pretty simple. A young martial artist's unparalleled Tai Chi skills land him in a highly lucrative underworld fight club. It's a very, very simple way of putting it, but why don't we go ahead and dive into this? Who would like to go first? Any hands? Because I will.
Ooh, right. Go ahead. Why not you?
Oh, yeah. Why not? Why not me? Jesus,
actually,
why not?
You could do it, man.
Before you begin, I got something for you guys.
Oh, great.
Oh, no.
I've decided to try and buy your love.
Nice.
You don't have to despite buy yourselves. Our love now, tonight. I know Patrick, Psycho Patrick,
yep.
Brought alcohol.
Yeah, nice.
And Patrick Rahul brought something scary. So nice. I decided to split the difference.
Oh, Weisenheimer Ale?
Better. Four Loco, baby! One for you! One for you!
What is it?
Do not give him Four Loco. Do not
what
give
is it?
One for you.
No, no, no.
What is
and
it?
And one for you, me.
Dynamo, chug it, okay? You got to chug it as fast as you can. That's the key.
What is it?
No, no, no.
Now, Johnny, as you know, it's called Four Loco, not Five Loco, so you get a Coke.
Oh.
What is it?
Drink it really fast and you'll find out.
You've never heard about Four Loco?
No. let's put it this way. This has made news, okay?
Yeah.
Big news.
Wait. Fun news.
Wait, I don't know if this is a good idea.
Loco, Loco, Loco.
I don't know if this is a good idea
well,
at all.
I'm not pregnant, so that's okay.
Look at Raven Shadow. He couldn't wait to drink.
Wait. When do we get it? When we get cheers on?
I'm not
going to
open
here.
Mine. I'm not going to open mine because I gotta drive. But
pussy.
So what? It's got alcohol. Is it like alcohol soda?
Absolutely. Just drink a lot of it very quickly.
Wait, What is that drink called?
Four Loco.
Holy shit!
You know, Isaac's
and
all right.
And that
man.
Is
he's
the reason
right
why.
What did you say holy shit for?
I just pointed out the alcohol content yeah to him.
Well, so, all right. Things are looking up.
I didn't think they have enough room on the can to put a number that high.
All right. This is a little detour. I wasn't expecting this. But all
right, let's go to commercial. Oh, wait.
Four Loco. It starts. Four Loco. Only four retards.
All right. Four Loco is a line of alcoholic beverages originally marketed as energy drinks. Is now sold in 48 states in Canada, Puerto Rico, Bahamas, Bolivia, Honduras, Europe. The name Four is derived from the original energy drink's four main ingredients: alcohol, caffeine, taurine, and guarana.
Alcohol, yeah, and taurine.
And a little booze thrown in for good measure.
Wait. And four branded products have been the object of legal, ethical, and health concerns. Stay with me. Related to the company allegedly marketing them to underage and the purported danger of combining alcohol and caffeine. After the beverage was banned in several states, a product reintroduction in December of 2010 removed caffeine, taurine, and guarana as ingredients, and the malt beverage is no longer marketed as an energy drink.
But they left the important ingredient. It's the one Loco you really need.
Jesus Christ. Wait, what's the alcohol content? Is that the 12%?
12% alcohol.
Oh my God.
It can't be that absurd. It can't be that tough. It says right here in small writing, it says drink four.
Scary thing is that it's going to take about five or six of these for Raven Shadow to get a buzz going.
This is a good start. I'm putting my car around. Start the pump.
You know, so I don't want to be like the beer of bad news. But it doesn't taste that good.
It's not supposed to taste good.
That's why you got to drink it really fast.
So here's the FDA warning. In 2010, the FDA, the U.S. FDA Food and Drug Administration, issued a warning letter to four manufacturers of caffeinated alcohol beverages, citing that the caffeine added to their malt alcoholic beverages is an unsafe food additive, and said that further action, including seizure of products, may occur under federal law. It declared the beverages that combine caffeine with alcohol, such as four energy drinks, a public health concern and couldn't stay on the market in their current form. The FDA also stated that concerns have been raised that caffeine can mask some of the sensory cues individuals might normally rely on to determine their level of intoxication. Warning letters were issued to each of the four companies requiring them to provide the FDA in writing within 15 days, blah, 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 blah.
This is fucking bullshit.
Meanwhile, cigarettes still safe the way they are.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
You're
at
welcome.
All. It's a good thing the government couldn't figure out how to make any money off Four Loco.
Can we just say this is fucking bullshit for the next 2 hours on a loop?
Yeah, we're gonna need it actually quite a bit for tonight.
Does Larry Fine think it's bullshit?
Four Loco beer? Oh boy. Let me see here. Strawberry lemonade Four Loco. Oh boy. Premium malt beverage with natural and artificial flavors and certified color. You know, Now you just wait a second there, Tiny White. I was there with Mo and I was there with Curly while we were making our own beer. You remember that all the way back in like 1937. It was a long time ago. Well, anyway, we were making this beer, and we all put the yeast in by accident. It was a fuck-up, you know?
It was a fuck-up.
Oh, boy.
This is gonna be a good show.
Is the review over yet? Holy
Treat.
Shit. Oh, shit. I can't recover.
Everybody wants time.
Oh, too bad there's a little roboting on that, because that was fucking awesome. Oh, man. All right. Everybody was Tai Chi fighting. Oh. How am I gonna fucking do this? How am I gonna
Here,
fucking review?
This is how you do it. Have a Four Loko.
Be one of us. Join us.
I've never seen one of these like ever.
No, your balls will drop.
Everybody was tiny. Hey. And drinking Four Loko.
Four Loko.
All right, I like this movie. It's good.
It was better than Van Helsing.
Yeah. Oh man, I can't do this.
Oh boy.
I need to compose myself. All right.
Have some Four Loko, it'll calm you down.
You know what I think about this movie?
It's better than Van Helsing.
All right.
Fucking Four Loko, really? You're all right, Isaac. You're all right.
Yeah. That's Sir Isaac, and you're welcome.
You're all forgiven.
Raven Shadow, where's yours? Did you drink it all already?
Oh, fucking God, man. All right, where's me a straw?
Are you fucking serious?
No, it's
okay.
Oh, okay. Jesus.
That drink is not safe. Radio. You can't drink that.
Yeah, that's not safe. No.
He's having a Miller Lite with a Four Loko chaser.
Yeah, it's fun. I'm a goddamn grown ass man, sir. Fuck that.
That's unacceptable.
Oh, Jesus God. Christ. All right.
I love how it says We ID right on the can.
12% alcohol.
It's so potent where even the can tells you that we're going to ID you for this shit. That's funny.
All right.
I don't even think cigarettes
even
do that.
The can is drunk. Even the cat is drunk.
Even the cat is drunk.
It's so alcoholic that even the can is drunk. I need something with more high pitch. Hold on. Hello. Much better. Yeah, that's much more comprehensible.
Tiny's not even here, and he's fucking drunk. All right. Let's go. Let's do this. Manitai Chi. All right. I thought the opening was pretty brutal. It set a nice tone for the way that things were going to go down in this. And
I think the neck snap was sounded a little weak, didn't you? Sounded like chiropractic.
Yeah, I guess the Foley could a little bit better. They should have had the Foley artist from Mandy Lane.
Ooh. Yeah, they should have.
Yeah. So there was one scene. Oh, it was I think it was when Tiger Chen. So let me just give a quick little. Now that I'm sort of getting in the space here, I can think about this. This film was sort of biographical, I guess. When Keanu was working on the Matrix movies, Tiger Chen was one of the stuntmen. And I guess he befriended him, and they became pretty close, and he was sharing stories about him when he was younger. And I guess a lot of what went into making this movie was Tiger Chen's actual life, and that's why he actually he goes by his real name, Tiger Chen, because it's sort of a biographical piece.
Really?
So I don't know how fictionalized it ends up getting or how much it diverts from his actual life, but I don't know. It's pretty crazy to think that even some of the stuff that happened in this film was real. Like, I certainly don't doubt it. I'm sure it happens, but you know, we've seen it on a number of times with Kumite, Bloodsport.
Yes.
So
some of us have lived it.
That's right. Absolutely. Some of us have even lived it. But there was one when he first started doing Tai Chi, they were showing him, I think he was fighting with his master. So this is Tiger Chen. And there was like, it was like all evasion. Like, I don't know a ton about Tai Chi, so I'm hoping you can speak a little bit more on this, Tiny. But it seems like, from what I know, Tai Chi is not about offense. It's not about striking. It's more or less takedowns and sort of controlling your opponent or your enemy.
That's exactly right.
Yep. Okay. So the four loco didn't get to me yet. But so I thought that scene was really cool when they were just fighting, like seeing two Tai Chi, you know, one master and one mentor and protege going at it. It was pretty awesome just to see the fight and to see how it flowed. And I think when he entered the tournament, when they first showed the first like legit tournament match, somebody said, Tai Chi, that's different. So it seems like Tai Chi, you know, and I'm just going based on this movie and the very little I know, it seems like it's almost like the black sheep of the martial arts world.
I don't think it's considered a fighting art, I think is all. Okay. I don't think you often see it in tournaments and all.
Okay, so if it's not necessarily, it's usually for health and living, right? Not so much as a fighting art. Okay, so so I thought that whole thing was pretty interesting because I don't know a ton about Tai Chi, but I thought the choreography in this was pretty good. Like the fights seemed pretty realistic, I thought, and you know there was a little bit of wire work, but not a ton. And so I think it just sort of had that balance of like realistic, and it was very grounded in reality. So I thought the fight scenes were all pretty cool. They're all visually different. They had something different going on. They had different styles for each fight. So I thought they were very distinct. Was someone going to say something?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought someone was going to pipe in. When Tiger Chen, he gets recruited to go into this sort of underground fighting, I don't even know what you want to call it, but this underground fighting circuit. And the first fight he has, that guy grabs his tie and just like fucking like is yeah. whipping him around. I thought that was pretty crazy, just seeing that fight play out. There's not too much we can get into with spoiler territory here, I don't think. I mean, we obviously won't tell the end, but I mean, in the synopsis, they pretty much tell you a lot of what's going on. And it's the way this movie just sort of flowed, it just kind of like got deeper and deeper and into this world. And it was interesting seeing such an innocent character, Tiger Chen, being sucked down into this. And I thought that was sort of one of the really interesting dynamics for me was seeing the seemingly innocent guy who had a lot of like sort of darkness inside of him, I think, or was very easily manipulated by other people. So some of the fights were just fantastic. That two on one fight, I loved with that strobe light effect. I thought that was really fantastic.
I found it disorienting.
It was a bit, but I thought it was different and I really liked it. I sort of loved, they were kept showing Tiger Chen in legitimate tournaments and then this underground tournament, and I just thought that was a really cool dichotomy to show the two different fighting worlds in this. And whenever he fought his master, I thought it was just phenomenal. Like, it just was so cool seeing the Tai Chi, the back and forth with the two. It was pretty amazing. And then, do you guys know what I'm talking about? The like WWE style hype video toward the end.
Yeah.
Oh yes. Yeah. I thought that was
pretty fucking awesome. And
I wonder. I'll wait my turn. I'll go next.
Okay. And you know what? I think I'm going to leave a lot of my final thoughts to the end because I don't want to step on anyone's toes necessarily. But I thought it was a very good versus evil morality play. And there was a lot of interesting, simple concepts going on with this movie. And I thought that Tiger Chen was like perfect for this role. He's a stunt man, but he's done some acting, but I thought he was just really perfect for this role. He had this innocence that seemed very genuine, and probably because he was playing himself, you know, apparently he was the character, like it's 80% Tiger Chen and 20% fictionalized. But I just thought he was really awesome, and it was totally believable seeing this innocent character getting sucked down into this dangerous world, so to speak. And Yin Wo Ping was the action director who is a fight choreographer for a lot of great fantastic films. Most notably, you guys have probably seen him. I know his work in Asia is probably more well known, but he was he did the Matrix films. He did all the choreography for those. But he's done a ton of other stuff. He's a really well known fight choreographer, and it was pretty cool to see him working on this. So I'll leave the rest of my thoughts till the verdict. But why don't you go ahead, Dynamo, and give your thoughts.
The thing I was going to say, the way he acted, the way he growled, the way he dressed in those kind of like men's warehouse suits, do you think that there was an element of, supposed to be an element of Vince here?
Because
I feel like
you're
the
talking
way,
about Keanu?
Keanu, because I feel like the way he built the propaganda and the way he, you know, treated his talent, you know, whether or not the legends, I've heard more contradictory accounts than the bitter ways of people complaining that Vince treated me bad or Vince was mean to me backstage. But, you know, like, it sort of seemed like an amped up Vince McMahon to me. And when it did hit that hype video, that really drove it home for me that I thought that maybe it wasn't just something that I was kind of contextually taking away. There might also be, I don't know too much about the guy that runs UFC, Dana White. Yeah, I don't know too much about that guy. He seems pretty mild-mannered, though. Like, you know, so this might be like a few things in. But I do think it was interesting because normally when you have one of these mob-heavy types, he also isn't like a producer of media, I guess, for lack of a better way to put it. And I found that was a really, really interesting thing here. As a whole, I was disappointed in the fights because I was very, very excited to see like the three or four guys who you know were involved in different elements of the choreography and filming of these fights, including in typical Dynamo fashion, his name escapes me now, but the guy who choreographed most of the fights for the Avengers was one of the main fight choreographers in this leg cramp review.
Leg cramp. Oh my God! What?
Wow. Here, have some Loco, man. That'll loosen it up.
Give him some Loco.
Come on.
Have some Loco.
Chug.
Have some Loco.
Chug.
Chug. Chug. Chug. Chug. Chug. Chug. Really?
That was more of a sip.
I feel much better.
With 12% alcohol, believe me, that's a chug.
Yeah.
Point so, taken.
I can't feel my nuts, but I feel much better.
MonsterZero.
Could you cross your legs while you're standing sitting like that in front of me?
Why?
You're sitting, you're pointing right at me, and you've got a leg spread out.
This familiar,
it's kind of creepy.
The familiar smell of your mom wafting over you.
Fuck you.
Then I'd have fucked two blazers.
She smells like like fish and chips.
Oh, boy, a blaze of glory.
So anyway,
I'll bring you four Loco, and this is how you thank me, you fuckers.
I feel like the fights started out fucking awesome. The first tournament fight, the sparring with the master, and the first fight in the room. Those were all A-plus fights, and I felt like we were going to have a contender versus the raid here. There was some pretty cool choreography and some really well-put-together fights. I stand by what I said when we spoke about the raid real early on, and that's like I think that films like this are going to affect the way that pro wrestling matches are put together because as opposed to like a lot of wire work and stuff like that, like – you can see all this unfolding. You know, it's all shot from away, and it's not shot like the typical American movie, like the Bourne movies or the Bond movies, where it's that shaky cam close-up that I think we're all in agreement that we dislike. There were some great fights here. Unfortunately, they ran out of steam by the time they got to the end. I think the first fight in the Underground tournament was the best fight, and I think every fight after that got a little bit less interesting.
The Thai one?
Yeah. Except for I did enjoy the one with the guy from Machete there and from the Universal Soldier movie getting knocked out with one kick.
Yeah.
That was pretty awesome. But I think that this movie lived and died by his fights. And, you know, Keanu is admirable that he was in camera a lot for a lot of that combat at the end. But that was a very lackluster fight, I thought. And I think that the overall story was fine. Like Wolfie said, it was very simple. They did a really great job showing this character's arc
they did a really great job with the politics of showing, you know, the not being able to save the temple and all that, that sort of stuff was all very good. The only problem with this was it was just kind of like a porno, like where like really good looking people like stood around and talked, and then they rolled out me, MonsterZero, and a couple of fat hairy broads to do the fucking. Like I feel by the end of it, the fighting was just like not just not good, just kind of bad. And that by the end of it, I was finding myself a little bit bored because it was relied more and more on the fighting and less on the shit about the temple and less on his kind of love interest who worked in the law office. And more on his real life acclimating to being a part of this fight club and when he was fucking in it and like full out killing dudes and stuff like that. I felt like those fights weren't very good and couldn't carry the movie.
All right.
Did you just say acclimating?
No, I didn't. I think I said it closer to right than that, but probably not right.
Stop drinking that shit.
Don't tell him what to do.
Is this a bad time to say that?
Acclimating.
Is this a bad time to say that before the Four Loko came, I just finished off a giant Irish coffee that I made on the way over?
Oh, boy.
So that's good because they took the caffeine out of the Four Loko, so you just put it in yourself ahead of time.
Oh, no. Oh, this is bad.
He's going to turn into the Tasmanian devil.
Just throw me down the stairs and you'll have an old school Four Loko all mixed inside.
Oh, Jesus. All right.
I'm really the Tasmanian devil.
Who wants to go next? Raven Shadow?
I can jump in real quick.
You jumping on this?
Yeah. I knew I would like this movie when I was over at Castle Wolfenstein a few weeks ago with Johnny, and we saw the first, like, 15 minutes. It kind of reminds me of, like, the Asian Argo.
What?
You know, because...
I haven't seen Argo yet, so I can't say.
No, but Ben Affleck, that was his big, you know, comeuppance.
Oh, I gotcha.
So this was Keanu's kind of, like, Asian Argo.
You're not talking about this ship from Starblazers right now?
No, that'd be a lot fucking cooler. Time.
Okay, gotcha.
Give me a call offline. We'll talk some fucking Starblazers, me and you.
Oh, that's... Oh, he can fucking hardly wait. He's already got it dialed. He's just shaking with his thumb over the send button.
Yeah, we'll get some Four Locos. I'll be Derek Wildstar, and you can be the Marines, and we'll look for Iskandar.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying, Tiny? Yep. Me and you,
he's
brother.
He's saying that Iskandar was Constantinople.
While they change right. It.
Because fuck those Turks. All right.
That's nobody's business but the Jews.
Whoa!
Hello.
Four Loko.
It's not me. It's Nicodemus that's racist.
I'm supposed to use that old name. Jesus Christ.
Send letters of complaint to Trick or Treat Radio. Carol.
Jesus, man. Why do you think we call Crazy old Rick? Jesus Christ.
That's awesome.
That's what Four Loko does to you, folks.
Exactly. That's what I'm thinking right now.
For Bloco.
I blew it.
Oh, man.
Is it still my turn?
No, it wasn't your turn. It was Raven Shadow's turn.
Fucking trying, man. I liked it. I liked I liked Tiger
Chen.
Tiger Chen Lee.
Tiger Jeet Singh.
I liked him. I liked how the juxtaposition between his like.
Whoa. It's a 25-cent word there, sir.
Did I say it right?
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, you did. That's the thing that screwed me up.
Now we want to know if you used it the right way.
Yeah. Can you phone a friend? You buy a vowel?
He did.
What's my phone? No, I liked how they were busting his balls in his day job, and it was kind of like, you know, he was doing his thing, the courier stuff, whatever the fuck.
I love that.
Yeah, right? Like, I enjoyed it. I agree with Dynamo where I think it got less... You know, the fights were less creative or interesting as it went on. But overall, I still liked it. I liked Keanu Reeves being the villain. I really enjoyed that. I've really dismissed Keanu over the years, but I had a lot of fun with this flick. I enjoyed it.
Have you seen Point Break, sir?
Don't fucking FBI agent.
I love Point Break.
I fucking Point Break's my shit, dude.
Have you ever pointed your gun at the air and just yelled,
Yeah.
Whoa.
You fucking Johnny Utah.
That's right.
Make that fucking sequel. That's a fucking movie. No, it was fun. I like the Kung to the Fu.
What talking about the tie to the chief.
Yeah, who knew that? I thought it was just fucking aerobics. I thought it was fucking Billy Blanks just did his own thing and made it up.
It's Ty Bo. It's very different. It's
really?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, yes.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Old people in the park do not do Ty Bo.
No.
I don't know what parks you go to, sir, but this is America. We won the war.
Did they did they do Ty Luke?
Yeah.
Ty Bo. Ty Luke.
It's fun.
Ty Duke.
It's fun.
All right. It was fun.
It's fun.
Great. All right, MZ, why don't you go ahead?
This is our worst fucking review ever.
It's because of Four Loko.
Four Loko.
Get to blame.
That's because I haven't started yet.
Isaac Blaze has sabotaged this whole thing.
Don't say his
Sir
name.
Isaac.
Jeez,
Sir Isaac.
Sir Isaac Blame.
Bloody hell.
Sir Isaac.
Sir Isaac, sorry.
Crazy old Sir Isaac.
Okay.
Have some more Four Loko. It'll improve your memory.
You know, this film is an amalgamation of a...
What?
What?
This film is an amalgamation of a whole bunch of other films. Cut that out!
For cockfish look.
Hey, I'm warning you.
I'm warning you.
Somebody take his pianos away from him, please.
Who knew that the Wow, you couldn't have sounded less hip there.
Yeah. I know, right?
Someone please take his crazy pianos away. That organ.
This is a combination of a whole bunch of films. Elements.
Treat.
Four Loko. That's what it does.
You got a very nice radio voice.
Oh my god, this show's gone off the fucking deep end.
Treat.
This show is mental. Oh my
You're
god.
Mental.
Totally mental.
Totally.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's Captain DJ.
See, I did it right that time.
Isn't it PJ?
Oh!
What was that?
I don't know.
I heard something.
Jesus?
No.
Raven Shadow looks a lot like Jesus. Hanging on the cross.
No, as I was saying before.
As he was saying before.
Oh, that sucks.
All right.
Yeah?
As you were.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
No, there are elements of a whole bunch of films in this film, of course.
A whole bunch of films.
What the fuck is that?
There are a whole bunch of films in this movie. I like this movie.
Do your review, dude. What are you doing?
Oh, shit. All right, yeah.
This portion of Trick or Treat Radio is brought to you by Four Loko.
Oh. I'm afraid to talk now.
Afraid to talk now.
Even give him one.
Jeez.
All right, go ahead.
Are you sure? Okay, like I was saying before.
I don't know what you're talking about.
This film is an amalgamation of a bunch of other films.
I live in the ocean.
The Matrix. Karate Kid 3.
The Matrix. The Matrix.
Tony, I hope you bought enough cocaine for everyone.
This is the most disjointed review ever. Just go, dude, go.
I'm trying to knock your shit off over there.
I'm trying to, dude.
Okay.
When did T-Pain join the Deadites?
I think we sold more records than T-Pain.
All right. There's a bunch of different.
I don't think I'm
anything. Just plow through it, MonsterZero. Just plow through it.
Okay, when I say go, you just keep going. When I say go, you keep going. You ready?
Yeah.
Power through it. Are you ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, go.
Okay, there's elements of films out there. Kind of like The Matrix, Truman Show, Karate Kid 3, Mortal Kombat, and other films I can't really think of right now because I got a beat in my mind right now. Awesome, great fight sequences in that mirror room in that contest that they had, that underground contest, as well as the legal fighting that they had going on in there. The fights are all really, really well put together. I felt that the wire work kind of slowed it down a little bit. To the point where the reality was really broken up in certain aspects of the fights. It didn't totally ruin the fights, but it did kind of make you notice. Yeah, you could tell the difference between what's real and what's wire work. Unfortunately,
did you take the blue pill?
Reeves. Reeves has never given a more wooden performance. He is just absolutely dreadful.
What you got to do is get yourself an education and a job.
Sir, yeah. I do not find what you just said appropriate.
I don't give a shit.
That dude is paralyzed. He fell off a horse.
Oh, shit.
Too soon. Huh? Yeah. You don't talk about him being wooden. Dude can't move his legs.
Can't move his legs. Can't move his whole body. He's dead.
Holy shit! And you're making fun of him being wooden?
It's fucking lame, dude.
Whack.
What I else? Have a layer of blubber to keep me warm in the water.
Me too.
What else would you expect from me?
MZ, yo, that's fat, low. You gotta get way warm.
But he's never given a more wooden performance. The tie-ins are there. As far as the Matrix goes, Keanu is basically Morpheus. Tiger is Neo. At least Keanu is Morpheus in the first half of the film because you realize that you know he might be a pretty decent person. Keanu also ends up becoming Terry Silver from The Karate Kid 3. So there's a tie in that as well.
It's nice to think anybody here watched Karate Kid 3.
What's wrong with Karate Kid 3?
I don't know. I never saw it.
Well, is that with the girl?
Sit on your ass and watch it.
That was the fourth one. Hilary Swank.
Yeah. And I thought the plot was rather mundane. It was the idea of Tiger Chen needing to pick up, you know, collect money to save a temple is not the kind of plot that I was expecting. I don't know, but I wasn't expecting that. I mean that I would expect from like Breaking Two, Electric Boogaloo, you know. It's, you know, when you're saving miracles. Here he's saving a temple. It's not exactly the kind of plot that I was expecting. Usually it's the revenge of a murdered brother.
Yeah,
or...
but that, I think that's what makes it okay, is that it's not what you expect. It is to be expected.
It threw me off. I mean, in the end, you know, I really didn't mind it. It's just not what I expected. And
so you didn't expect a tournament fight movie to have the tropes of a tournament fight movie?
No. I didn't have the idea of a fight movie needing to be what it was because of the temple.
Did you think that this was the samurai movie with the CGI dragons that we saw the preview for in the theater? Because I did. That's what I thought we were watching.
Would you rather a phone booth show up and they go back in time and get the world's best fighters to have a tournament?
Now, that wouldn't be such a bad idea.
And George Carlin shows up?
That would not be such a bad idea. You know that. You know that wouldn't be such a bad idea.
We should write that.
The cam work was really good.
Does that exist? Wait a minute.
No, Tiny, get a pen. We'll make this movie.
Get a pen.
The cam work, I thought,
the creators of Hobbit with a Shotgun. Somebody call Patrick Rahal. Come on, let's do this.
The cam work was really, really interesting to me, especially when involved in that mirror room, because you got the camera work going on right in front of the camera, and I always found that to be very interesting, because you never see that.
The camera work?
No, you never see the camera shoot in front of the mirror.
Is it hump day?
This is really going to be difficult because everybody's drinking fucking Four Loko.
Not me.
Jesus. Not you.
You should.
And
everybody drinking Four Loko. Everybody drinking Four Loko.
You're going to kill Dynamo.
He's gonna puke! Oh, he's gonna puke! Go film it!
Swallow it!
Film it! Film it!
You're
gonna film it!
Go get him! The other way!
Jesus Christ! Did you see that, Tiny?
No, I missed that. What happened? Did we lose him?
Tiny, come over. Tiny, just come over.
You get a picture of that.
Two people were just out of the room.
Dynamo just said that Four Loko shot out of his nose.
Oh, man.
Now,
that means it's working.
That means that everything in the fucking world is shot out of his nose now at this point in time.
Jesus. Out of every fucking orifice in this kid's body, man.
That's it. Yep.
Oh, my God.
Boobs? Booze aids. Is that like Band-Aids?
We just started over.
I know, right?
Can we scrap this episode?
Welcome to Trick or Treat Radio. All
right, let me just finish it off. Okay, let me just finish it off.
Come on, finish it off.
Finish yourself off.
Finish it off. Finish him. Finish him.
All right. Shut up over there. Jesus.
Finish him.
Yeah, he said that a lot. He also said, "You owe me a life. You owe me a life." Wait. You know, he was getting repetitive, and he's starting to piss me off.
His other catchphrase that he said all the time was,
"Whoa,
does it matter?"
Yeah. Yep. And I mean, like I was saying, the camera work was really interesting, especially when you got the camera shot. When you got the camera shot going on right in front of the mirror, because you never see that. I mean, the only other time I saw that was early this year when at World's End, the World's End came out. Camera work was on Keanu Reeves' character, whose name I forget, near the end of the film.
Tanaka Mark.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. It got really, really cheeseball and real hokey. And he just started in with his overacting, and he just put out a tremendously wooden performance. Everyone else put out a rather decent performance. Tiger Chen was fantastic. I thought he was very realistic. I thought his fighting skills, fantastic. I mean, all the performances were really good. But, man, Keanu Reeves, he just doesn't have it. And it seems like he tried too hard. Or maybe the fact that he was directing and acting at the same time, maybe that kind of threw him off. I don't know, but
he doesn't do them at the same time.
Well, no, but I mean, he is directing and he is acting.
Hi, Keanu, action.
Right, doesn't film. Even matter. just say your lines.
All right, Keanu, action. I said action. cut.
Let's go to commercial.
You know what? I'm going to stop right now.
What's my motivation?
This was the most exhausting review I have ever done in my life.
Have some Four Loko. It'll make you feel
better. Maybe I should.
All right, let's. We gotta get through this. We have two more people to go than the verdict. Isaac,
Sir Isaac,
give us your insight, okay, Mr. Isaac.
Son of a bitch. Okay, I'd heard good reviews of this, so I figured I was probably gonna end up liking this, but it was a lot better than I thought it was gonna be. I was very impressed by this. It's so funny that Raven Shadow mentioned Ben Affleck and Argo before. I'm just gonna fucking ignore you, Tiny. Do your worst. Fuck you. Too pussy to be in a studio if that's real, man.
And drink Four Loko.
Do another line of blow. Jesus. And where was I? I really liked, Raven Shadow mentioned before, yeah. Ben Affleck and Argo. It's funny he mentioned that because with Keanu Reeves and Ben Affleck, you got, for me, they're both actors who, they've never really impressed me
in with lead acting roles, but they seem to do really good behind the camera. Right. And I think they should both stay there, frankly. This is a very well-directed movie. He knew how to shoot the action scenes. It wasn't cut. It wasn't extreme close-ups, no shaky cam. He did the long shots. You could see what the hell was going on. He would hold the shots for more than a couple of seconds.
The
thing
that's
also
true,
really liked
true.
Was the character progression of Tiger Chen. As he start, the aggression that he accumulates throughout the movie, it's earned. What's I going to say?
What was I going to say? I can't remember.
But I'll remember
what
it now.
I wish it wasn't roboting.
I'm not MonsterZero. You can shut up now.
It's only the high notes, Tiny, that seem to distort. When you take it low, it seems okay.
Oh, Tiny likes to take it low.
As Tiger progresses and his style becomes much more aggressive, you know, he starts to lean towards the dark side, but he doesn't turn into Captain Asshole about the whole thing. I mean, yes, he gets more money. In a lesser movie, he would just become a flat-out jerk to everybody he knew. But at the same time, he's using the money to fix the temple. He buys nice things for his parents. Yes, he's much more aggressive. And I liked how the more he fought in the underground matches, the more he started to seem... He seemed to develop a real contempt for the legal matches.
Yeah.
Did you listen to us?
I'm trying to go back and cut out.
And you can sort of see, without him ever actually coming out and staying, it was almost like, you know, you go through an underground match, you're fighting for your life, it's either you win or you get fired, and who knows what that means. And then he's got to go, and he's got to, you know, hear the rules, you know, two men, don't, you know, stop. He's got to listen to the referee, and, you know, you can just see the contempt and how he just becomes much more aggressive, and it was a lot of fun to watch. But again, he becomes more darker and more aggressive, but he doesn't go completely evil. And that's what I liked about it. They showed that restraint, that he wasn't going to go all the way with it.
He doesn't go balls deep into evil?
Exactly.
All right, Tiny, how about you?
This movie was.
Is it on Twitter? It interrupts you now, Tiny. Anytime you're ready, Tiny, you go ahead and give your review.
The good and bad and the bright and dark in the world. I guess I liked it.
I turned down Isaac's mic for you. I don't want to ruin the brilliance.
I watched half of it so far.
What did you think about it, Tony? Go ahead. Anytime you're ready now.
I liked it.
Thinking for Loco.
I thought the fight scenes were, I thought they were really good. The wire work was offensive because it was so good without it. You know what I mean? Like the throws and the grapples and stuff like that were brilliant.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, as I was joking on vocoder, this movie, to me, I think this movie is really about that whole yin and yang thing that they sort of, when his master, like, put him in the center of that yin yang or whatever, there's a name for that symbol besides just yin yang. But, you know, he put one foot on each of those dots in the movie, you know, to sort of express the idea of balance in what he was doing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think he was meant to his master was meant to, you know, represent the good or the light, always in white, and obviously Keanu Reeves' character was the darkness. So it was
the darkness.
It's unfortunate to hear that the fights get worse, having not seen them. But I'm still looking forward to watching it play out.
I don't agree with that, by the way. So
what's that?
I don't agree that they get worse.
No, I don't think they do.
I thought they were great throughout.
Yep.
Great. Okay, cool. So, yeah, I look forward to watching the rest of it. But I'm really impressed with what I've seen so far. I don't think Keanu Reeves' acting is too fantastic. If anything, that is somewhat the low point in it.
Hey, Tiny. We're getting roboting pretty bad.
Yeah.
You're fine now. Go.
Okay, sorry. I'll keep it short. Okay. I think Reeves has some high point acting, but his low point acting is pretty weak, pretty bad. But I really enjoyed it so far. I look forward to watching the rest.
Cool. There we go. So We got some live feedback. Keanu Reeves only knows one line. Keanu Reeves doesn't need to know any other lines. Just show up and look baffled. Paid.
Who's that?
That's a
the Tao of Michael Ravenshadow.
The Tao of Ravenshadow.
My fucking milkshake brings so many fucking boys to the yard.
Yeah, just boys.
Yeah, and the cops are just don't ask questions.
Hey.
All right, we need to go ahead and give it the verdict. So why don't we cue that up right here? Oh yeah.
Trick or treat, baby.
I wonder if people would say you're a trick or a treat.
Trick or treat, motherfucker.
All right, now we're going to go ahead and give our verdict for Man of Tai Chi. And I guess I'll kick it off because I went first. So let me just say, I think that this was a very good-looking film. Now, whether Keanu was solely responsible or not, or whether he surrounded himself with some really good people, either way, like, it worked. So I don't know. Either way, he gets the credit, yeah. whether it was all him or whether he surrounded himself with really good people. But sure. I thought it looked beautiful, and some of the scenes were just shot really well. The action was filmed. He films, like, this action is filmed so much better than most Hollywood blockbusters these days. So, I mean, obviously he learned, I assume, from The Matrix, you know, that had some fantastic action scenes there. So, and the fights I thought were pretty fucking good. I don't agree with Dynamo. I don't know if they necessarily got better, but I don't think they got worse for sure. I do think that the best fight, I'd say probably the final showdown was, well, actually, no, I think one of the Tai Chi fights with his master was probably the best, but runner up, I would say, is the final throwdown between the...
Really?
Yep.
I felt like that fight was off. As a fan of martial arts films and good and like fight choreography altogether, like I felt like that was lackluster.
Okay. I thought there was plenty of room to breathe. There's no super close-ups or any choppy editing that we're so used to nowadays with fighting. And I also really liked the score. I thought it had a pretty fucking good film score, and it was very fitting for the style of film. I did think that Keanu was kind of annoying, his character in this, and I think that was sort of the point. I mean, he's not a horrible actor. He's not great either. You know, like, he in some of his roles, he's fantastic. Like, in The Matrix, like, he was great, I thought. Both with the fighting and just being, you know, Neo is sort of like this aloof sort of character at first who sort of learns more. But I thought he was a little annoying. But I think the role was supposed to be that, so I don't think that it just was him being bad. I think that's how the role was written, and I think the film had a very reserved feel to it, with moments of aggression, and I think that sort of embodies Tai Chi and the struggle of this character, Tiger Chen, and I thought it played very nicely for the type of story it was telling. It was a nice sort of analog for Tai Chi, and the very little that I know about the style. And there was some interesting themes going on. There's definitely the old versus new, with the temple sort of about to be taken down and taken over, and you know, have like a new new development built on top of it. So there's this like old versus new and good versus evil were like sort of the overriding themes, and I thought they were played brilliantly. Like, it just was so sort of understated, but and very simple. But I think that made this movie really shine. And I think that I just love the story arc of Tiger Chen and the way it's portrayed. And I really enjoyed this movie, and I'm definitely going to recommend it and say it's a treat. Dynamo.
I'll get out of the way and say that I think it's a treat as well. Maybe maybe we'll say it a tepid treat, but I disagree with you on just about everything that you said. I feel like this
is... So call it a fucking trick?
No, because I enjoyed it.
Don't cop out here.
No, I enjoyed the film, but I also think that it was entirely very busily directed. I think that it had a lot of film school shenanigans.
Really?
Yeah.
Like what?
Anything that was not the fight scenes or character interaction was shot through a weird filter. They did all that, like, that time.
I totally disagree. I don't know if your color was off on your TV.
They did all that time, showing the sun come up and sun come down, and, like, all that sped up like photography and like I didn't like that stuff one bit. And there was some other directing stuff that was very MTV like. But the important part in these films is the fight, and for the most part, they left the fights alone. I feel like the last fight could have used a little more direction, but that might have just been Keanu, no pun intended, not being able to punch his own weight.
I disagree there. I mean, he did all his own stunts in I don't know about this. I assume he did all this, but in The Matrix, he got to the point where he was good enough that he could do all his own stuff. So he's certainly no chump, you know? Like, he's not a master, I wouldn't say, but...
Is that true? I mean, he had a stunt double in The Matrix. That guy went on to his own, like, films.
He did almost all the fights, though. I'm sure he had a stunt double for stunts and stuff like that, but the fights were mostly him, if not all.
I mean, I don't know. Like, I feel like you're championing something that I consider almost the nirvana of films. Like, I feel like The Matrix ruined movies for a while, specifically action movies. So that's not a huge impressive thing to me to say that he did anything in The Matrix.
Well, it still is the fact that he did it.
Yeah, he worked hard.
That's the point of
it. And I think he definitely, it was admirable that he went out and did it here, but I think it hurt the product. You had such a good fighter, and you have so many great fighters at your, access. That stunt team is phenomenal. I recognized a lot of the guys, like the dudes that all showed up and were going to take him away before the police showed up at the end fight. Like, those are all pretty, like heavy stunt guys that you see in a lot of these things. And, like, any one of those guys, there's a couple guys from The Raid kicking around on the stunt team. Like, you could have had an epic ending fight. But we didn't. He only had an okay fight. Well directed, well written, but as like just a fight for fight's sake, I didn't think it was that great.
Okay. Next would be Raven Shadow.
Yeah, I mean, I'm somewhere in between all you guys. I did enjoy this. I liked.
What's
sounds
that?
Like a fucking oil drum.
Oh.
I think Keanu didn't put himself over. I think he held himself back. I liked him playing the villain. It was a fun flick. I love The Matrix. I hate the two sequels. But I think it was a good job. I liked him in the Vince role, which I didn't think about until now. Overall, and I think Tiger kind of came off as like an Asian Keanu. A little bit. In certain scenes, like, I'm not sure what the Asian word for woe is, but he could have said it.
Yeah, I could, expression-wise, I could see that.
You know what I'm saying? Like, but I thought Keanu held back, and I liked the fact that he's the ugly American playing the heel. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
In a weird way. Like, it was fun, and like, if anything, this jump started my interest for 47 Ronin even more.
That's what I thought we were going to watch.
Yeah, we should.
I was so confused.
We should go to, like, Yong Sheng and then go watch that movie when it comes out.
It's not a bad idea.
It's pretty good. All right, Four Loko, treat.
Do they serve Four Loko at the Yong Sheng?
Yeah, they can get it. They get some.
We'll sneak it in.
Yeah. That was a Four Loko treat?
Yeah, so it was a Four Loko treat. It was fun.
All right, MZ.
All right, I'm just waiting for Tiny to do something.
No, you go, you go. You're
okay,
good.
Thank you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Tiny, just let him do it, for fuck's sake.
You know what? I'm taking off the goddamn... There we go. And, okay. Now I got to think about what I was going to say.
Jesus.
Okay. No. All right.
No. Go.
No. Keanu Reeves, man, he is just, it's like he's a block of wood, man. He's like Dean Malenko of the acting world, okay? He's a block of wood. That's all he is, with a woe attached to it. And I don't think there was a woe in this movie, now that I think about it. Okay, that being said, the fight scenes were really great, you know, and I'm going to express with everybody. The fight scenes were great. I thought the final battle at the tournament itself was fairly decent. Now I don't have admittedly, I don't have a knowledge of martial art films like Dynamo has.
The one where he's running away? That one, or the one where he beat the crap out of the guy?
At the tournament. I don't know.
There's
I don't
two
know
tournaments.
What he's talking.
No, there's the underground tournament and then
the underground tournament.
Yeah, okay. And there's the one where he didn't fight, though.
Yeah.
That was shot awesomely, by the way. To make that look exciting and not like a Three Stooges shtick was pretty impressive.
Yeah.
And it just seems like the fight sequences were just there to string along a series of just boring sequences. You know, I'm going to put these back on because I feel much better putting them back on. There's something about it that I just didn't particularly care for, and it was just very, I don't know how to put it.
Try.
I'm trying, man.
Just say trick or treat. Yeah.
Treat.
Yeah, let's leave it at this. Trick.
All fuck right. You.
Trick.
Fuck me. Fuck you.
That's a bad boy.
You didn't like it.
I didn't like it. I didn't like it because Keanu Reeves is such a no talent.
Fuck you.
He's
he
such
was fine,
a no
man.
Talent. He was fine. He was fine. What are you coming on to him now?
Are you saying just his acting, or are you including the directing in this as well? When you say that he sucks.
I thought he was a fine director myself. I'm just not
for
into
a first
that
time
sort of
out.
Stuff.
Yeah, for a first time out, it's not terrible.
Yeah, it's no
but we're that's true. But where when Wolfenstein's saying that was it you that said that he was like holding himself back or he made himself look what was the word that you used?
Reserved?
Yeah, I think maybe it was. I don't know.
Have some more Four Loko.
Yeah, you should be drinking that. You're the only one not drinking it.
This well, show, trick.
Fucking tiny with his goddamn piano oh, shit over there.
Don't blame it on his piano shit.
Now you're fucking tiny, too?
Yeah, yeah, I didn't say anything. I'm letting you wrap it up. Oh. Go for it, man.
Oh, my God. What? Remember the old days of plugging in directly to the computer? Those were awesome.
I just didn't particularly care for this, except for the fight sequences were good. The performances outside of Keanu Reeves were really, really good. I thought Tiger Chen was fantastic. I thought the wire work,
so
I thought
you're basically
sucked.
you're basically saying like 8 out of 10 things are good, so it's a trick.
This is similar to your review of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre remake. You're like, it's shot well, the acting's well, yeah. there's good kills, I hate it.
Because Keanu Reeves is the reason why this movie exists.
Yeah.
But he's just, I mean, I'm not going to say that one person brings down an entire film.
But you are.
But you are. Yeah.
But you are.
But let's be honest, that is possible. You know what I mean? We've seen plenty of movies where one poorly written role or one badly acted role just destroys a movie.
Does anybody else have Skidamax?
Well, I don't think he's... It's not that he's terrible. He's so wooden, though. He's just... There's nothing there. I see him, and there's just nothing there. And it just bores the hell out of me. And I start laughing at the screen.
Is that what you're trying to say? There is no spoon?
There is no spoon. And I start laughing at the goddamn screen because of this guy. Except for the part... And I especially started laughing when he did that huge scream. He was sitting on the couch or
that
his bed
great.
Or whatever. He just let out that... Oh, God awful scream.
I wrote that down in my notes. That was great.
Raven Shadow.
But I didn't care.
Hold on. Let him finish.
Yeah, come on, guys.
When did he finish? When did he start?
Shut up. So I mean, I just didn't care for it. Trick.
Okay. Sir Isaac.
I did like this. I did think it was a treat. For a first feature film, I thought Keanu was a great director. I liked the character arc. I liked the acting. There were fight scenes aside, which there were great fight scenes in this. I really liked them. There were little things outside the fight scenes, little twists and sudden surprises that occurred that I really thought made this film great. I do have to call bullshit on one thing, though. Nobody brought it up. I don't want to reveal too many spoilers, so I'll just say this. Wind blast.
Mm.
Everybody know what I'm talking about?
Sure.
Are you good?
It's that one thing. Well, you kind of gave it away there.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
I like the handprint.
The wind blast, I mean, it occurs twice in the movie. It's like something out of a Japanese cartoon. It's bullshit. They didn't need it in this movie. That was the one thing I would complain about. Because everything else is, you know, considering this involves underground fight scenes and lots of cameras and stuff like that, it's the one thing that is suddenly, like, right out of fiction. And it didn't need, this movie didn't need that. I just thought it was a bullshit thing. It didn't need that. But other than that, this movie was a treat. It wasn't enough to ruin the film for me, but
well, that's good,
I think they could have just taken it out.
Let's get Tiny's thoughts on that. Is that possible, Tiny? The chi energy move there?
Well, let's not get into that. But I think that that served a very important role in this movie, which was to speak of the difference between the physical and the spiritual world, right?
Yeah,
so
yep.
He is basically saying you can fight as hard as you want and you can hurt people and everything, but you'll never achieve this level, you know. And I think that fight scene was pivotal mm-hmm. in that movie for expressing the difference between his path and the path that his master was trying to bring him on.
Right. The one thing that I will say is if you pull that move in a tournament, you are cheating.
No, that's fair. What are you talking about?
No. That is cheating.
It still felt like a bit of a cop-out. It was like, okay, Master Yang can't defeat you through regular means, so we're just going to create this Hadouken move, the super move, so that he can win.
That fight, I feel like Keanu channeled and kind of aped one of my favorite fight scenes of all time from Fist of Legend. Like the way they shot it, like, you know, uh-huh. pushing back and forth against each other and the close-up, like the torso
uh-huh.
like cam of it. Like,
mm-hmm.
How would you guys rate the fights in this, like, comparably to, like, another film? I'm just curious because I really feel like I'm really surprised that you guys like...
Which
what
film?
Put yeah. against the, which film?
No, like, I'm, that's what I'm saying. Like,
who do you think that's sexy?
Who do you think that's sexy?
Let me put it to you this way. Who do you think that's sexy?
Oh, wow. Here, have some more Fro Loco, man.
No, who's your Asian friend?
Who do you think that's sexy?
What was the...
Clearly, I'm falling behind with my Fro Loco drinking.
Who does Dynamo think he's... Who does
Ryan
Dynamo
Gosling?
Think he's sexy?
Hashimoto.
Bruce Lee?
Hashimoto.
I do not think Hashimoto is sexy.
Hashimoto, right, okay, yeah.
Cute.
Cute.
Not
cuddly.
Sexy.
Cuddly. Well, what was the movie called?
Oh, My Zombie Mermaid.
There you go. Compared to that,
this is much better fights than that. But
yeah,
it is truly.
I mean, I guess if you want to compare, like you would compare this to other
like
films
Bloodsport?
In the genre, not even necessarily Bloodsport, but maybe even Raid Redemption. Potentially, you know, it's a different film, but there's you know,
yeah, I don't.
There's a little bit of that edge to it.
There was a more serious sense of purpose of the fights in this film rather than Oh My Zombie Mermaid, though.
Sure.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's hard to... Yeah. We can't compare
I would say that
you can watch it right.
Raid is the pinnacle of this kind of new style.
Absolutely.
And this is not that. I'd say this is close to a little... I think there's a little of this, but still relied a little bit on that Matrix foo.
Yeah, and this... I mean, I guess it all depends. You can't even compare this to American films, like even, you know, like Avengers or even Dark Knight Rises or whatever. Like,
yeah.
You can't. It's just totally
no
different.
Avengers, sir.
I would say that.
No, I'm just saying like
they
an
have
American.
Same fight choreographer, though.
Well, I would put the fight scenes in this movie well above the Batman trilogy.
I agree. Mm-hmm.
And I would, too. And, and I'm a big fan of that series. But
I would compare it to shot better. Well, not shot differently. Because these fights were more better. But I would compare it probably closely to, say, Kill Bill. Like, I feel like it was a very westernized mm-hmm. version of, you know,
okay.
an Asian martial arts film.
Yeah, I could see that. Okay.
All right. Tiny, are you going to give it an incomplete? I knew you didn't see the whole thing, but do you want to go ahead and give your verdict?
I'll already give it a treat. I mean, I don't know what could go wrong in this that would really push it over to that, you know, 50% mark for me. Some of the fights in this I thought were just awesome, really fun to watch. The one, you know, his intro fight in front of the mirror and all was pretty impressive. And the dynamic of the fight was really good, too. I do wish they had just not done wire or not, you know, not done any of the moves that would require a wire, like a triple spin or something like that, you know. When people are in the air for too long, it just takes the edge off of it. You know,
I think you got to commit all the way or not at all.
Yeah, something like that.
And this was sort of half-assed.
What was the rating on this? Was it R?
Yes, rated R.
Yeah, so I think where I think they missed is there are plenty of kung fu movies that don't get very edgy, but I think if they got a little edgier with this, with the evil in this movie, mm-hmm. it would be well served. You know what I mean? I think it would be well served by adding a little edge and a little bit more evil to the evil in this movie. It was almost like a parable. I don't know, like a morality play or something like that. And it felt a little soft in that sense, even like snapping necks and stuff like that. It wasn't very visceral. Like none of the kills and really none of the violence was very visceral. It was like really well choreographed, I thought, but not very visceral.
Right.
But still, I'll say treat.
Okay. So there you have it. There's one trick, and the rest of us say treat, even though Dynamo is more of a tepid treat, I think. But, you know, check this out. If you dig...
I'm really surprised, to be honest.
Surprised that there are some treats?
That you guys
treats?
Like it as much as you do. Like, I would say I like it, but...
If they did with the action in this movie what Ip Man did with martial arts action, this would be a better movie. And it's similar. It's just not as rough. I don't know how to put it, but it's there's less impact.
I'm certainly not going to put this in the same category as Ip Man because that movie's fucking good. But this was a fun movie, you know. And you know, it does have its flaws for sure, but it was fun. I mean, I love the fighting. I thought Tiger Chen was awesome. I'd love to see him in more stuff. Hopefully, this is sort of a catapult for him, and he can get some more roles because he was really a lot of fun to watch in this.
He'd be a great Shang-Chi.
Shang-Chi, mm-hmm. Yeah. So there you have it. There's our review of Man of Tai Chi. Watch it. Don't watch it. Whatever the fuck. Right, Raven Channel?
Yeah. Well, go fuck yourself.
Jesus. Well, I wasn't gonna go that far, but.
What are you gonna do?
All right. So for next week.
Hey, go fuck yourself.
I was actually hoping to. There's a movie playing in Boston this weekend that I really am hoping we could go see, but that's. But regardless, I can't count on that being our review.
Wait, what are we talking about, though?
I don't think everyone's going to make it. There's a movie called The Visitor, a sci-fi film from the 70s that's playing.
Oh, shit.
Really?
Yeah, that's like that Draft House story. One?
It's a Draft House film. So
what time on Saturday?
It's 9:45, I think.
I could do it. Late.
I was thinking, I'm like, that can't be the same movie.
After Megafest?
After Megafest?
Mm-hmm. I can probably do that, too.
Yeah. Saturday after Megafest, maybe? All right, well, if we do it, we'll do a 2-4.
I do have a friend coming home, so as long as she's down. She's up from, I almost said Texas, up from Los Angeles. She's from Folsom, Los Angeles, which I always assumed was in Texas before she moved.
So let's do that. Let's do that as an audible. If we can plan it and go see it, let's do that. And that'll be we'll do a 2-4 next week, okay? We'll do two reviews because we don't have an interview scheduled next week. So
I bet the librarian's down too.
If we can go see it, it'll be awesome. I'd love to see The Visitor. And but the one we're going to pick for sure, our featured review, is going to be a film called Grabbers. This is available. What? What's wrong with that?
Raven Shadow, what's the title of that film?
What's the name of the film?
Grabbers?
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 Hey, Raven Shadow, what are you doing today? I'm going to visit my grabbing grandpa.
Grabbers. I know Graboids.
So, Grabbers is a film from 2012. It's an Irish film.
Oh, fuck. Oh, it's Grabbers.
Hey, fuck you.
Irish. Yeah. And it's available.
People are smart enough to make a movie.
It's available on Netflix Instant, so go ahead and queue that up, and you can play along at home this week with us.
Does the film camera have a hand crank? Because I don't think they discovered electricity yet.
And I think it's an alien movie.
Aren't they all?
Hey, Sir Isaac, when you leave, we're going to play a nice little round of IRA. I'm going to leave a little something for you in your car.
Nice.
Yeah, warm it up. Yeah, warm it up.
Yeah.
This is Invasion of the Body Grabbers.
Grabbers.
Yes, it's in the Invasion of the Body Grabbers. So
over the river and through the woods, the grabber's house we go. Grabber got run over by reindeers.
The 1 week Brave and Shadow didn't bring any Little Debbie snacks. Well, I help you stuff him into his mouth myself.
Oh, you haven't even we haven't gone to break yet. Buckle up.
Ooh, this looks pretty interesting. Yeah. I like this. I like this cover.
Yeah,
it's like the funky Cthulhu.
Ooh, yeah, man. It's like a pub with a Cthulhu action thing going on in the background. A
little grabbers.
Little grabbers.
Some grabbing.
Little grabbing's going on.
Watch that on Black Friday. Come over to the house. Watch the grabbers.
Jesus Christ.
Just come over, Johnny.
All right, so
please come over.
So that's going to be it. All right, let's cut to a commercial. We'll be back. Right, let's regain our composure, everyone. Okay, we'll come back. We got about a half hour left with MonsterZero. Sober up, everyone. Go have some have some two loco during the break.
Why would you
want
to sober up?
All right, so let's go ahead and we'll cut to commercial. We'll be back in just a couple minutes.
All right, man, we really got to record a promo for this thing.
Should we write a script for this?
Nah, fuck it, man. We'll do it live.
Hey, folks, this is El Goro.
And this is the Cancer Man.
And we are the hosts of Talk Without Rhythm,
the only podcast that will not attract the worm.
That really doesn't explain what we do.
Well, we watch two movies a week, we review them, we bullshit, and sometimes we say something funny.
Yeah, but most of the time we just piss people off.
Well, the American film-viewing public can't handle most of what we have to say.
But if you think you can find us on iTunes if you do a search for Talk Without Rhythm. You can also find us on our website, tworpodcast.blogspot.com, baby.
Deuces.
Hello, everyone. It's me, Jason Voorhees. You want to keep up to date with the world's greatest monster hunting electroshock, world-saving superheroes there are? Well, me, I could care less for those sons of a bitches. But if you want to, go to Twitter, @TheDeadites. For Michael Ravenshadow, that's the A in the half parentheses, @TheDeadites. Keep up to date with tour date. Sorry. Upcoming shows. Oh, my goodness. New releases. Hot date. All right, anyway, I'm sorry. @TheDeadites on Twitter. Follow everything about the Deadites and Trick or Treat Radio, which admittedly is not a whole hell of a lot.
We are back from break. What'd you think of that new promo there, Dynamo?
I'm pretty happy. I really, El Goro's a good buddy of mine, so yep. I'm just glad to hear it.
And Tanya actually said that that's...
No, don't wreck it. It's going to be part of my double tap.
Oh. Okay.
We're going to go there,
huh?
Those guys just gave me a double tap idea. Thank goodness.
I wish they gave me one. I don't have any. So we have. I'm getting messages. They're not in the Google Hangout, but getting messages from friend Tanya, who's saying that she's loving the conversation. These are all her favorite movies: Ip Man, The Raid, Untouchable, and then she says, "Grab a hay."
Nice,
nice.
I can dig it.
Yeah, I thought that was pretty awesome.
T Dog. I gave her a nickname already. You see that?
Yeah.
It's not very.
That's kind of like Tiny White, though. TW, T-Dog.
No, we don't have to do that. No.
T-Dub.
We can, yeah, that's it.
BT-Dubs.
This is one of my favorite Deadites songs right here.
Fucked Up and Lost. With the,
it's different.
With
yeah, it's
Mr.
different.
Mr. Kirvin's on this one.
I thought your favorite was The Executioner's Lullaby.
Fuck you.
All right. What are we going to do for this half hour before we MonsterZero go? You want to do double taps now?
Yeah, let MonsterZero do it. When's the last time MonsterZero got a double tap?
Do you want to do a double tap?
I don't have anything to do a double tap with.
Blah, 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 blah.
You don't have
can play messages.
Yeah.
How about if I talk about this?
What if you talk about words with friends?
Talk about what? What do you want to talk about?
remember how I was telling you about how we were going to talk about this?
This is gonna suck.
Shut up. go drink. go drink and have fluids or flow out of every orifice in your body.
They're blocked. They're clogged.
All right. What do you want to talk about?
About the photo that I Dynamo took a couple weeks ago of me.
Oh yeah. Let's do that. It's on your Facebook, right? Is that? Because I need to quote. I need direct quotes.
Yeah. I want to quote it myself too.
No, you don't get to quote it. All right. Go ahead and tell the story about the picture. I'll find these.
All right. Well, anyway, a couple weeks ago, Dynamo was taking pictures of everybody, as he usually does, because he's got nothing else better to do. And he took
better than grabbing you.
Grabbers. Don't grab me. And he takes pictures of everybody, and he posts it on Facebook. And we all do that. So anyway,
he's doing it right now.
Yeah. And he took a picture of me that was less than flattering. That, in my opinion, anyway, and I was completely unshaven, and my hair was all over the place.
You're like an unshaven rat.
Yeah, I know. I'm a piece of shit. Well, anyway.
Well, it wasn't gonna go that far.
Well, I don't mind. Come on, look who you're talking to here. There it is.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah. Yep. And like I said, it was a less than flattering picture, and I'm giving him the side eye as he takes the picture.
That's like the stink eye.
The brown eye.
The brown eye for the gay guy. Dude, I'm horrible. Why am I such a horrible person?
I know. You homophobe.
Don't you turn my brown eyes blue.
Brown eye for the hobo guy.
I mean, what are we going to call you, Johnny Homostein?
Whoa!
Jesus.
It's a Four Loko talking, folks.
Yeah. Well, actually, I'm not drinking it, but man, it stinks like Four Loko in here.
Oh, my Lord.
You're welcome.
Really, that's all I smell in here is Four Loko. Oh. And anyway, so he's taken a picture of me, posted it, and there were some comments, and I responded to them in kind, and everything. But there was this one that
this one's even better.
brings in an ongoing joke that involves me and a certain Italian horror actor.
Yes. Ain't no yes. joke. The motherfucker yeah. wanted to fuck you.
So, whoa! That is the Four Loko.
Is that bad?
So here, let's go back.
I just want to shit on your dick.
Not everyone.
Jesus.
Well, hold on.
The Four Loko is running wild over there.
Oh my God.
Let me tell you something, brother. The Four Loko's running wild.
Ooh, yeah! Woo! Couple Four Loko.
This is not good. It's not good.
No. All right, let me go back in time because not everyone probably knows this. But
yeah, let's do this.
So our good friend here, MonsterZero, is a big fan of Italian horror, as you all know. Yeah. If you listen to any of the episodes, you'll know this. So,
Como si dice?
Si dice?
Como si dice?
So anyways, he is a big fan of Giovanni Lombardo Radice. What films was he in?
Oh, man, he's been a lot. He's been in, like, The Church, Cannibal Ferox, City of the Living Dead.
The Erotic Nights of MonsterZero.
House on the Edge of the Park.
Yep. So he's been a lot of films here. And so MonsterZero is a big fan of his. And our good friend Mike Baronis, he does all kinds of stuff with the Italian cinema. He books conventions. He books, like, when they have the reunions.
Well, he doesn't do it anymore.
Right,
he
doesn't do it anymore.
Cindy Mullins to take care of that business now. He's off on other ventures now.
Yep. So, but Mike was pretty much the foremost authority for Italian cinema when it came to conventions. And, and it's because he did the film Para, about Lucio Fulci. So he knows a lot of these people. So anyways, Giovanni was at Mike's house. And he knew how much of a fan MonsterZero was, so he called up MonsterZero and was like, hey, come on down. They call him Johnny, right?
Yeah. Johnny.
And so he's like, Johnny's here, come hang out, come meet him, blah, blah, blah. So you go down, right? Yep. Go hang out with Mike and Johnny.
Yep.
And why don't you go ahead and tell the rest?
Okay, well, I hung out with the guy for about maybe 45 minutes, 50 minutes, and just chilled out for a while and just, you know,
just being banged.
Just being a fanboy, I just like was like asking him all sorts of questions. You know, I'm honored to meet you and all this other stuff. And,
one knuckle, two knuckle.
And he was like the very first Italian horror celebrity that I met. So I was really, really, really excited and happy to meet him and everything. And later on that evening, he said to me that I was his
do
most.
Do it in the voice. Do it in the accent.
I'm not going to do it in the voice. I'm not going to do it in the voice.
You know, I know a guy who does an absolutely drop-dead impression of That's Giovanni true. Lombardo Radice.
Oh, God.
Coming into the studio. Here, hey, Giovanni. What a nice thing. It's like, this is your life. He's in the studio now.
And he said to me, and it seemed to be really serious, he said that I was his most attractive fan.
No, most handsomest fan.
Most handsomest fan.
It's the same thing.
What?
Handsomest, attractive.
Tomato, but why don't you just blow him, dude? This is fun. It's fun.
You would know.
So anyway, he says that I'm his most attractive fan.
Handsomest
fan, attractive fan.
Open your mouth and say ah.
Open your mouth and say ah.
I'd fuck the shit out of my favorite horror celebrity.
Yeah, yeah, we all know that. We all know. And she would run for the hills if she ever knew.
I'd run for her hills.
I know. So anyway, that's the story on that. And
So you guys hug out.
Yep.
He thinks you're a very handsome man. You're his most handsome fan.
Yep.
And we need to get that.
He told me that.
Yep.
He told me that.
We need to get that shirt made up.
Yeah, let's do that.
Giovanni's most handsome fan.
I should have a shirt with my face on it, and on the back says, Giovanni Lombardo Radice's most
was
handsome
here.
Fan.
Yeah. Oh, I wear that.
Pointing down.
So, all right, so Dynamo posts this picture of MonsterZero, and MonsterZero reposts it and says, Jesus, I am one ugly fuck.
And
you look good, dude. You look good.
It's an odd picture. I'll
not
say
that picture.
Yeah, no, it's he's giving him like the side stink eye. It's not a very.
It's all leverage.
Yeah.
What?
Well, I was very tired at that point.
It's all angle and leverage. Yeah, it was 5 o'clock in the afternoon.
Snappy whippersnap, better watch out with all the photography jargon that's going on at that end of the table.
But no, you look good, man. I like the hair growing out.
So Mike Baronis posts on this photo and he says, "Thoughts, Giovanni," and he tags Giovanni, and then Giovanni.
Yeah.
Writes back. This is
no
the
way.
Giovanni
no.
Lombardo
no
Radice.
Way.
Yeah.
Is that for real?
Yeah.
He says,
is that for realsies?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He says, thoughts? MonsterZero, if you doubt about your sex appeal, come over to daddy.
Cryptocast like a motherfucker.
If you doubt about your sex appeal, come over to daddy.
Yo. Take one for the team, son.
Yeah, no shit. This is your fucking...
That's so special.
My God.
MonsterZero, let's have a family reunion.
Bring Rufus and Ronaldo. I'll put him up for the night.
That is fucking awesome.
Yo.
That's not it.
Yo.
Daddy?
Incest is in the game. The whole family can play. Come play with me.
I'm not done. So MonsterZero says, well, Johnny... I may not be a member of the gay community, but I'm indeed honored. So Giovanni says, well, I am bisexual, actually, and never say never.
Dude, you have to.
Please.
Fuck you.
One time.
One time. Take it for the team.
No.
If we got your lady friend on the phone right now and said,
she would be fine with this.
Would it be okay if MonsterZero... like had a you know had
That's
some meatballs in his mouth.
It's getting colder out. Why don't you make some Swiss Miss hot chocolate, shovel the walkway, and just get snowed in?
Now let me just chime in here.
No, you can't.
Because I really think I ought to say something at this point.
It's too late. Just hush. Whatever you say, you have to say it like Larry Fine.
Oh boy.
Look. I am honored that he finds me that attractive. I really do. I mean, I'd be stupid not to. I mean, I have no, I like,
Look, I mean, I might joke a little bit here and there, but I have absolutely no problem with homosexuals.
Oh,
and,
wait,
and absolutely
is he a bisexual?
No, and absolutely no problem with lesbians, although they seem to have a problem with me for some reason.
Yeah, they do.
Which is funny, because you look like most lesbians I know.
You wear the collar up.
Oh, I love lesbians.
Oh, you mean I look like a guy? Thank you.
No, it's fun.
And, you know, I am honored, so, I mean, I'm not... You know, put off by that at all in the slightest. You
Where
know?
Does
I mean,
he live?
He lives in he lives in Rome, Italy,
right?
Rome, Italy. Yeah.
Think about it. We fly MonsterZero to Rome
we're
with a camera.
We're not flying my ass
I'll
to Rome.
Well, that's the only part he's interested in. But we're gonna fly your whole body.
It's just a one-way ticket, right? Yeah.
Oh shit!
But I mean, he's a cool guy, and I mean, I'm not put off by it in the slightest. I mean, I mean. It figures that the only person in the world who finds me attractive is a guy, but I mean that seems to
it's
be the story
fate.
Of my life.
Any port in a storm, sir.
But a famous guy by a show of hands. How many other people have a famous person that will fuck them if they want that? Hands.
Oh, I knew Dynamo's hand would go up.
Oh, all right, divulge.
Yeah. Who is it?
Mind you, I'm not talking.
Then why you put your hand up?
Put your hand down, man.
Yeah. You don't count.
Angela Bettis would bang me.
No, oh please.
Yeah, if you could muster the fucking courage to say two words there.
Yeah, maybe if she had AIDS.
All I need
she
to
would.
Say is. You...
Oh, God damn it! That was terrible.
Now don't forget. Giovanni Lombardo Radice was also in the Omen remake as well.
Oh Jesus! That was horrible.
Not only was he in me, but he was also in the Omen remake.
Listen, you are the only one. That I know, and probably the only one that you know, that could say you swallowed a load from an Italian cinematic legend. Don't drop this ball. Like, that's like saying you...
Figuratively or literally.
You know, you caught a... You, like,
if
you, know,
you drop at the ball, I'll put it back in your mouth.
Like, you caught a... You I don't know, do it.
Seriously, yeah,
I mean,
nobody's fucking... chiseled your epitaph yet.
No. Is that a metaphor? Was that supposed to be a metaphor?
Fucking do it.
No.
Yes.
No. Yeah.
Come on, never. Ricci, all on your
wait,
face in this moment.
Oh, God. Let me put it another way. Dynamo, if B&B Hulk walked in the door right now and said, Dynamo... I will bang you.
Banged.
Bang, bang.
No ifs, ands, or buts about it.
B&B Hulk?
Yeah.
I would catch for B&B Hulk, too. Like, which isn't like something I
normally
say.
You don't know who B&B Hulk is?
He's you have to show him an intro, yeah. I think. He's an Asian man. Like, if what I learned from the ABCs of Death is anything to say, like, I could handle that.
All right, let me see if we can find an intro.
He is beautiful, though. As I get older, I am not afraid to admit that there are a few men in the world that I find attractive. I wouldn't bang them.
Now, have you even heard what Giovanni Lombardo Radice sounds like?
No, play us.
Yeah, he sounded like this.
All right, hold on. You
heard the messages he leave it to this show.
All right, hold on. I'll play a little something for you. Hold on.
Richard, pick up.
Were you a voicemail from him?
At times, my voice was capped as it was in the Omen at times I was dubbed. At times I dubbed myself in Italian. At times
that's Sir Isaac.
I had a sort of a French accent in Italian.
You wouldn't want to hear him whisper sweet nothings into your ear.
Well, I might fuck him.
Hook
Dynamo up.
Get some mozzarella sticks.
Pull a train
maybe,
on him.
Yeah.
Wait. I think this is. We haven't heard it in a while. He needs to vibe. Let's hear it. What does he need to do?
What you gotta do is you gotta put some hot pockets in the microwave. Mm-hmm. All right, it's getting
some spicy Italian ones.
Yeah, you can put. I would put a fan on to offset the oven because the kitchen is getting hot now.
Hot.
Mm-hmm. But
boiling
maybe.
Hot.
Yeah, get a space heater. Get a space heater in the back, and maybe you guys can put your sweatpants on.
Mm-hmm.
Just take them off a little bit.
You could put on double sweatpants.
Yeah, just enough to move them.
Good little fan going.
Yeah, the fans are on. You get the plastic on the windows.
Flapping.
Yeah, it's... and maybe just talk about the cinema. That's fun.
Yeah, maybe get some macaroni.
Candles.
Or some gravy.
Candles.
Huh?
The, candles? Yeah, yes, candles, the yeah. sauce. Yeah, sauce is called gravy if you grew up in the Italian community.
Yep.
That's fun. Mm-hmm. Why don't you do that? And yep. that's sexy, man.
It's good, different fan.
I have a question for you.
I'm not doing that.
You're going to do that.
How do you know, okay, how do you know you won't like it?
Yeah, you don't. You don't. It's like, have because you had fish?
I'm not gay.
You don't know
you
that.
You have to be.
I do know that.
Dude, no, I can tell you from many a drunk Deadite show that a blowjob is a blowjob is a blowjob.
He sucked my dick.
What? That never happened. I don't think.
No, but you could say that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
I
true.
Mean, if you're going to have a guy suck your dick, you're going to start with him?
No, I'm not going to, but I think for you.
Did he use teeth?
No.
No, but you should.
I don't think that there's any. I think, listen, I don't. Gay sex, straight sex, whatever you're into, but, like, if somebody loves you that much, who are you to hold out for that?
There you go. There you go. Just enjoy it. Just
vibe, man.
Spread the virus.
If you love someone so much, it's wrong to not give them the love. Are you listening, sexy librarian?
Oh,
wait,
God.
Here's the B&B Hulk entrance, I think, right here. I'm going to play this and stream it.
You better cover you guys' self with something. He's gonna go off like a water wiggle.
So, for those of you listening to the podcast, we're showing B&B Hulk, a Japanese wrestler, coming to the ring.
The arena is dark right now.
Yes. We're set the scene here.
Yep.
Dynamo's pants are tight.
There are lights. There's a giant Japanese-style ramp, like a mile-long walk.
And there's a big wet spot in front, but that's normal for him.
Look at him.
Nice. That was me.
That was you going off.
His dynamo exploding all over the place.
His pants finally gave way.
The funny thing is, we're showing this for Michael Ravenshadow. He's not looking.
I know.
I don't think he's going to do it. Oh, come on.
He's got it.
Nice.
Look at him. He's like an Asian alfalfa on steroids.
Shut up. Oh, my dynamo. Oh, my dynamo.
Oh, he's got to do it. He's got to.
But there's no ladies.
It's true. Oh, I'll be really fucking disappointed. Oh.
You know what? When he won the belt, he was trying to be a little more serious. Remember? Hmm.
What was it you thought he was going to do?
He hit an awesome thing.
Dance.
He does a great dance. Choreographed dance with a bunch of hot Japanese girls.
So anyway, I mean, like, the end result of this whole thing is the fact that, I mean, the fact that he says, come to daddy, I mean, kind of, it didn't exactly throw me off, but I'm like, well, that was pretty straightforward.
Yeah, I would say so. Yeah, Yeah, that's an offer.
It's Anthony Amore.
Wolfenstein, can you play that Aphex Twin song, Come to Daddy?
Sure.
Hey, I think that
seems appropriate.
All I'm saying is if someone loves you that much, like, throw them a bone.
I'm not throwing anybody.
Literally.
Yeah.
I'm not throwing all right, a bone.
Here we go.
Are you so afraid of...
Then let him throw his bone
afraid.
At you.
Why are you afraid?
I'm not afraid.
Listen, if Raven Shadow quit smoking, will you fuck that dude?
Here we go.
Here we go. My pants are tight as hell. And this dance is about to start. Here we go. He's doing an awesome dance right now. It's way sexy.
What is this, solid gold?
It is well choreographed, I'll give it that.
Yeah. I hope it is solid gold, because I have a 14-carat boner.
Don't reach anywhere over to your left, Isaac.
Overstock, can we trade seats? I'll give you some more Four Loko.
Look at his hips.
Oh, God.
Come on, that's a good-looking man. Look at him. He's like, dynamo, yeah. Dynamo.
Look, there's a difference between about me and you.
What?
Giovanni Lombardo Radice would definitely hit on me. There's absolutely no chance in hell that B&B Hulk would even look in your direction.
He does have a point.
You don't know that. You know.
Oh, come on. Look at you, for Christ's sake.
Look who's talking.
What do you mean, look who's talking?
The ugly fuck. The self-admitted ugly fuck.
Yeah, self-admit. Hey, at least I can admit that I'm ugly.
Good-looking dude.
Jesus Christ.
All right, we're going to hook you up with Giovanni.
It's going to be fucking awesome.
No, you're not. No, you're not.
Date. We're going to film it like that date show. What was that date show? Like, they'll be in a hot tub together, and, like, it'll be subtitled because you can't hear it over the hot tub. What was that?
I don't know. Catfish.
The real world?
I got to go.
That's convenient.
I am literally, like, you know, on behalf of, you know, people that aren't afraid, all over, gay, straight, otherwise, I am literally offended by how repulsed you are at the prospect of giving love to someone who loves
you. Seriously. Just enjoy it.
That's it. Yeah, that's really shitty of you, man. You know,
to
deny him.
Deny yourself.
He's bisexual. He's perfectly fine without me. No. He can walk around with the white pages under his arms, for Christ's sake.
Here's the thing. Here's the thing, though, which is interesting. A first ballot Hall of Fame Italian film legend.
See.
Has probably jacked off about MonsterZero.
Oh, my God.
You know, I never really thought about that.
Oh, Richard. Yes, you have.
Yeah, no, I haven't.
A, you have.
Now I have, yeah.
B, you have.
You might as well confess. We found the tissues.
That's fun, man. Like, I wish Quentin Tarantino would think about me.
Me too. I'd bang him, too.
Yeah, that's fun. You should enjoy
it.
Yeah, tell your mom.
Does your mom know that this man loves you?
I don't know.
Let's call your mom.
Yeah, let's call her.
Do your parents know that they made someone that an Italian filmmaker wants to have sex with?
Speaking of your parents, if you go on the Trick or Treat radio board, you'll see some nice childhood memorabilia that I found of MonsterZeros in a box. The giant.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. Yeah.
Right, I am really disgusted, sir.
Didn't exactly work, did it?
What?
The coat hanger.
Nope.
Because I'm still here.
Well, it had a nice inscription on it. It said, try again next time.
All right. Well,
I am pissed off that you will not, like, if you can't love, be with the one you love, love the one you're with. So.
You know, I've done one or two bad things in my time, but what you're doing is worse.
So I'm just going to put this out there. I will get him to quit smoking for 2 months if you kiss Giovanni.
Bullshit.
Which part?
Bullshit. Yeah, I call it bullshit on that.
Why? He'll quit.
I'll do it for a week.
I mean, he did.
That's
give
a 30
me,
second kiss.
When
all right, can he use his hand?
No, listen to me. Listen.
Wait,
to me.
Wait. When, how about a glory? He, how about right. a glory hole?
All right. Raise the last star.
When. I mean,
one hand from one Italian
when I left guy. When I left Mike's place, I mean, he I guess all Italians do this where they give the kiss on the on all both right, sides.
But
of
they
the
typically
face.
Don't give you a reach around too.
MZ, I've known you since 96. Have I ever kissed you on the cheek?
No.
No. Come here.
It was that one time.
I'm not gonna kiss
one
you.
Time. No, but this no. if you use your hand.
No.
If you have what if you had popcorn?
No.
I would have map.
No.
The popcorn trick.
You really are homophobic. It's terrible.
No, it's not.
Yeah, you are. Why do you hate gay people?
Why do you think
Dynamo's hobophobic and you're homophobic?
I said that I was honored that he thinks of me in that way.
Yeah, but you won't do anything about it.
Why do I have to do anything about it to prove myself?
All right, his last offer. Will you take your shirt off while he touches himself?
There's nothing gay about that. You're just hot. Not. The room is hot.
It's
would you strip to I touch myself while he touches himself?
Yeah. No.
You were, all right.
In the bath.
No.
I will make out with Miss M if you make out with.
Oh her. Yeah, yeah. The only person who loses on that is her.
And that's fair.
Way to put yourself out, Dynamo.
Yeah.
That's a fair sentiment.
I'm just waiting for her to put herself out.
What male actor would you tongue kiss at least?
Charlie Hunnam. Wait.
Let me ask you.
Wait, we weren't even asking you.
None. Now, let's say
okay, let's see.
Ryan Gosling or is it Gosling or Goslin?
Gosling.
Gosling. Ryan Gosling and B&B Hulk.
A little bit messed up for me this week.
Ryan Gosling and B&B Hulk both came to you.
Well, oh, who would you do first? You'd be balls deep in both of them.
What?
Who would you do first?
Oh, no, they could saw a log on me all day long.
They pull a train on him.
Yeah, for sure.
Dynamo goes.
But who would get the map?
Dynamo goes slaloming.
This is going bad.
Black racer from the Jersey.
Gaping.
Downhill skiing.
Oh, this is going bad.
Let's go to commercial. Either way, no matter. Look, I'm just honored, and I'm still honored, and I'm still flattered, and I should be, and I am. And you won't
do anything about it, so it's all bullshit.
I always look forward to the time where I get to run into him again. Maybe I can run into the guy. I never know.
Ram into him?
I would run into him. Bastard.
I would be honored to have Ryan Gosling bang me while B&B Hulk danced. And you won't, you know?
No. The only reason why you say that is because there is no chance in hell that could ever happen.
That's not my fault.
So you're saying there's a chance you and Radice could happen?
Because he knows me and I know him, yeah. But I'm not going to – it won't happen.
How do you know we won't have one of those guys on the show soon and they'll fall in love with my roguish charms?
Right.
Grabbers.
Next thing you know,
grabs.
I'm full of the driver's dead man's bone.
Oh man!
All right. Well, we gotta let MZ go.
Yeah.
We gotta cut.
Oh God, I feel sick.
That was the creepiest segment we've ever done. Are you happy, Sir Isaac?
Oh yeah. Okay. Here's a quick question now. Okay. Radice plays with himself, but you're fully dressed as Marilyn Monroe. Would you do that?
No. No.
Happy birthday, Giovanna Ribisi.
A wig, nice watch, a nice white dress.
No. Earrings?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. If you want.
All right, then yeah.
Cock rings?
All right, we got it.
We got one.
Your choice. Heels
book
or
it,
flats.
Book it.
Done. Book it, Dano.
Hi, this is Dynamo. Welcome to the CryptoCast on this week's show. I'll tell you what. If Giovanni got MonsterZero drunk, that would give the term Italian splatter a new thing.
All right, we need to cut to commercial. Raven Shadow's favorite part of the show. Oh. So MZ is gonna leave us. So MZ, why don't you say goodbye to the folks?
All right, I'm out of here, and I'll see you all next week. Arrivederci, douchebags.
We interrupt our program with a special bulletin.
Okay, here we go. This is it. Greetings and salutations.
I'm Josh Thrapp.
And I'm Scott
LaFave. Oh, good for you!
We want to let you know about the Arkham Film Society.
We're a small group of cinephiles covering sci-fi, horror, cult, and exploitation film events in the Providence, Rhode Island area.
We have such sights to show you.
We try to meet a need for unconventional programming by providing affordable film events through our monthly screening.
Be one of us.
Find us on Facebook and join our group by searching for the Arkham Film Society at facebook.com/Arkham Screenings.
Check out our blog at arkhamfilmsociety.blogspot.com.
And stop by our Etsy and buy stuff at etsy.com/people/Arkham Screenings.
Yes, sir! Yes, sir!
All
right, already, I'm hip!
We now return control of your television set to you.
Who's that?
Oh, yeah. I'm back from break. It was a quick one, baby. And Sir Isaac busting a move. At least he's not busting a rhyme.
That was for all the ladies out there watching online.
All one.
Still single.
All one of them.
How does it make you feel that MonsterZero can get laid if you can't?
What are you talking about?
That one goes out to all the lady.
All the lady. He could get laid.
Hey, here's a real question.
You think I can't get enough for hypno? Fuck you.
Why isn't Giovanni ever on the show?
Ooh.
Because there's like 5-hour difference, probably.
You don't think he'll stay up for Rich?
Ooh, he's already
for who?
MonsterZero. I'm blowing it.
So is he.
I'm just saying, if he did blow him, it would be a good CryptoCast episode.
we have to block some of that out.
And that's okay.
Yeah, I think
there's nothing
okay.
wrong with that.
No, not at all. Nothing at all.
You know why? May I suggest that we put VHS like tracking issues in it if we do that?
Oh, it's fucking B is for. Thank you, Tang.
All right. Well, we have a double tap to get to. Who would like to go first?
I'll go first.
Tiny, you're roboting though. Let's reconnect real quick.
Oh.
I can go first.
All right, go ahead.
Me?
Yeah, the person who said I would go first. Right.
First up, I read a lot of magazines, but I'm not a big magazine collector. I kind of just, you know, leave them next to the can or, like, have them wherever so I can pick them up and read them. But Rue Morgue magazine, the Canadian-based iconic horror magazine, is really blurring the line between monthly publication and great collectible resource to keep. A few months ago, you saw, maybe over almost a year ago, you saw me double tap their 100 Alternative Horror Films book. Every Halloween, they come out with a big themed issue. This year, my double tap is 50 Years of Gore. They have great articles on Argento, Lewis, Savini, Fred Vogel even. Like, it's a great book. They have all the normal compartments, like the Videodrome and the great music section. Like, this is a great book. Some people hate on Rue Morgue because they don't just focus on films. They focus on horror culture. That's why I love it. That's what I love about Rue Morgue. I love to see what I'm going to put nerdy stuff. I'm going to scatter all over my house, whether it be Dexter coasters or a Norman Bates knife holder. Like, you know, I've bought a ton of cool shit at Rue Morgue. This is a great magazine. They also have a great podcast network. I highly recommend Rue Morgue if you're looking for the definitive horror magazine. Fangoria is great. Horror Hound's great. Fangoria puts out a great magazine now called Gore Zone. But Rue Morgue is where it's at. For the most part, it's well written. It's very... They don't pander to their advertisers, which I feel a lot of horror magazines do. Rue Morgue magazine is where it's at. I don't have a music one this week because I actually had two comics that blew my mind, but I wanted to make sure that I got the Rue Morgue in, so I'm going to do one comic this week and one comic next time we have a double tap. In this comic, there's two things I fucking love from my childhood. I adore them. One of them is very obvious. Even though it is my job to extinguish them from the universe now, I'm a big fan of zombies, whether it be literature, film, funny books, cartoons, whatever. I am also... something that not a lot of people know about me, a big fan of the Riverdale gang, and I love me some Archie. I really, really enjoy Archie.
I know where you're going with this. Keep going.
Last month, the first issue of a great-looking comic called Afterlife with Archie came out. It's kind of like a... It's almost like somebody did a horror movie and is making a, like... just use the Archie comics like as a kind of a paritic thing. This is a beautiful comic book with beautiful artwork. It's very well written. I highly recommend Afterlife with Archie. This is a great looking book. And though they claim that it's going to be a PG affair, I find that it's kind of a... It's one of the better put together zombie comics that I've read in a while with their take on Sabrina the Teenage Witch, essentially starting a zombie apocalypse. It all starting because Jughead's dog gets run over and he wants
Jughead,
to come back to
Jughead.
Life.
Jughead.
It's a fucking cool comic, a very funny comic. And for anybody who grew up on those two very different, but very big staples of my youth, you will highly recommend them. I highly recommend this.
You will highly recommend
you will highly recommend this to me, and I will read it.
You know what? It's getting close to December. Do you want to do next month, do some holiday gift picks?
I have my gift picks all together, actually.
So maybe we'll do sort of a
group holiday gift pick.
Yeah, maybe we can do, instead of like, essentially that's what the double tap is, but maybe we can just sort of refactor it a little bit and do gift picks or something.
Yeah, I try to do contemporary things usually for the double tap, like I'll just do shit that's good for the gift thing.
Yeah, yeah. And so that could be stuff that we've talked about previous. We can bring that back.
This art is really good.
That's the movie I couldn't remember.
Hellbenders?
Yeah. Oh yeah, the art is great, and it's a great comic, and I loved the Archie and Kiss comics. That was a very fun, nostalgic, like, you know, fusion of two things again I grew up with. I felt like the Archie and Punisher comic was brilliant, how they fused those two worlds together, and it didn't take much away from either one. And this is like, this is a little different than those, because this is a little more, I hate to use the word edgy, but I mean, it starts with Jughead's dog getting run over, and like, you know, ends with a zombie Jughead like hitting the prom.
And I hate Archie.
Of course you do.
But this looks kind of good.
It's fucking awesome.
All right. So Rave Chatter, why don't you go next?
All right, I'm gonna bundle. You might get two, you might get three. Buckle up, see what happens. And my taps are stuff we've talked about. Over the weekend, I watched The Purge.
Nice.
The DVD joint.
Did you like it?
I enjoyed it. I think everyone kind of knows what The Purge is about. I think Ethan Hawke was the shit. I liked the premise. I'm not going to get into the premise. If you fucking know The Purge, you know, fucking bang it. I think it devolved a little bit into a typical home invasion movie as it progressed, but I find myself thinking about the world that allows one night of killing, horror, and stuff to happen. Like, it's almost like St. Patrick's Day, where you're like, all right, everyone's getting fucked up. We'll pick it up in the morning. Like, my thought is, if you can't afford a security system, what's the travel industry like? Like, you think that people would, like, fly
What the
out.
Fuck are you talking about? Jesus Christ.
Holy cow.
I thought, like, we were talking about The Purge.
My head started to hurt really bad, Jesus. Really quick. I was like, what is the travel industry?
Tiny, why don't you interrupt him?
I'm just going to let it go. Just going to let it, just no, let it roll. Like, let it roll.
Thanks for nothing, Tiny.
Let the babble roll.
No, I think I see where you're going.
Let the sentences go round.
Hang on. I'll see where you're going with this.
Don't drop that mic stand on your nuts, Sir Isaac.
Don't tell me what to do.
You can hold it if you want, but I'm just warning you.
What you're saying is, if there was one day and you knew that as soon as sundown occurred, all the shit was going to hit the fan and everybody, including your next-door neighbor, could take a gun to your face or your kids, you'd want to get the hell out of the country for that day.
Right, right. If you couldn't afford a security system, maybe you go to Mexico.
Yeah, so you're going to be able to, buy
idea.
A trip.
But then it's safe.
That's what's fucked up. Like, you know what I mean? Like, if the one night where Americans are wreaking havoc and you can't afford protection, maybe you go to Europe.
Fucking Durex or Trojan, man.
Different that's not kind that shit. No. You can't fuck your way to safety on that night, sir. But
I want to give a Richie safe haven.
No, you forget. You guys, who hasn't seen the movie?
I haven't seen it.
Pull his Trojan horse into my gates.
Although I will admit, the idea of one night where you can do whatever you want and the cops won't stop you sounds fucking awesome.
Yeah, but
it's like
here's the thing.
Devil's Night.
The setup sounds awesome.
Yes.
But I know the movie is not about that.
No.
That's
not
just
as cool as you want it to
exactly.
be.
Exactly. And that's why I don't really have any interest.
Yeah, like, I feel like it's a very high concept to get to your next.
But my thought is, like, that's where I'm going
just
with
have a
travel.
Fucking, just have a fucking break-in, you know? Like,
but that's
have,
thinking,
have a home invasion.
With a travel idea, like, all right, we'll go to England. And I would think, like, Europeans would love
just
this night. Yeah.
He could be your travel agent.
My fuck is excited.
I'm not going to England during the Purge. I'm staying right here.
We'll take your fat American dollars. Like, I'm more interested in the world that allows this night to happen than the movie. Although Ethan Hawke, or whatever the fuck his name was.
Oh, is he your B&B Hawk?
No, it's still Charlie Hunnam.
Though he dropped out of 50 Shades of Grey?
I feel like I've really let everybody, like, let their inner, like, bisexual man out, you know?
You're very freeing.
Yeah.
Well, close the fucking door, motherfucker.
I'm like, I am really like the Moses of
Are you a gay Moses?
Adulterous gay sex.
Oh, man, I just harkened back to the gaping conversation and him talking about Moses. Let's move on.
All right, potting the Red Sea.
So the Purge.
Yeah, check it out.
Parting the Brown Sea.
My tap two and or three would be
this sexy librarian just left.
Come back! What are you doing?
Nice. Wait, was his first tap international travel? I missed it.
Yeah. No, but you know, Isaac, fucking goddamn it,
Sir Isaac
is the voice of reason for my tap. I also watched This Is the End.
Okay, is that your? Are you tapping it? You don't sound very confident.
I'm just telling you.
Well, move on to your second tap.
Sherlock, episode one.
You can't. I tapped that last week.
But I'm because of your tap, I watched it.
Okay.
So I'm reiterating with your boy.
This is bullshit because I couldn't tap Dead Man's Bones last week. You flat out wouldn't let me.
I didn't know he was gonna do this.
I watched your boy Benedict Cumberbatch.
Benedict Cumberbatch.
And I enjoyed it.
Don't get me started.
Who's?
That's not a tap, though.
No, wait,
was that your tap?
No. Yeah.
Sherlock episode one?
Yeah.
It can't be.
It was good.
It was good. I had fun.
I tapped that last week. You can't do it.
I'm tapping.
Talk about Charlie Hunnam's ass or something.
All right, Charlie Hunnam. And actually, not this week, but last week, total BSO moment.
That's the name of the episode, Charlie Hunnam's ass.
And I enjoyed the Seth Rogen joint.
This is the end.
Yeah.
All right. Sir Isaac, do you have something?
What the fuck?
You guys are missing my point.
What's your point?
Right. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank
my
you.
First tap. This series is a TV series that comes on FX. I discovered it on Netflix streaming. They got the first three seasons up there.
Does it have Charlie Hunnam in it?
No, it does not. This is a great show. It's an animated show called Archer.
Okay.
This is a fucking brilliant show. It's about a secret agent. He drinks too much. He shoots people. He deals with severe mother issues. And something about the show really, really speaks to me. I don't know what it is.
I don't know either.
It's funny as hell. A lot of adult humor. And I highly recommend it.
It is pretty funny.
The other recommendation, my second tap, is a comic book. Now, I think we can all be pretty much in agreement that there are way too many fucking Batman comics around.
Yep.
Yes.
Too many writers, too many artists. I mean, the continuity is a mess.
There's only two good ones.
Out of a dozen now?
Yes.
Two dozen?
And they're adding a weekly one.
Shockingly, I'm actually going to recommend one. But the thing that makes it work is it has nothing to do with current Batman continuity. I'm recommending Batman 66.
Oh.
Three for a loop.
I thought it was Legend of the Dark Knight, but sure.
You're three too late. This is 69.
Oh, no, Batman. As I was saying, it's a pretty simple premise, but they've done a really great job of it. The idea is it's basically a comic book series based on the 1966 Batman series starring Adam West and Burt Ward.
Big in the pants.
They got all the characters. I don't look at that part. They've got, I mean, the dialogue is perfect. The artwork is perfect. Mike Allred is drawing the covers.
Oh, that's killer.
Perfect.
That's killer.
The guy inside, the guy's doing the interior artwork. It's not Michael Allred, but it's close enough. It's in that kind of vein. They got the over-the-top everything. I mean, it's just great. And I think if you're sick of what's going on with current Batman, you'd really get a kick out of this. It's silly, and most importantly, it's fun to read.
There you have it, folks. There you go.
Mm.
Tiny, how about you?
Yeah, I'll go. So what inspired this first tap is that our new advertisers talk without rhythm. So that I may be misinterpreting, but I believe that that's a reference to at least a concept in Dune. It's a quote from the movie, but I'm not sure if it actually appeared in the book or not. Frank Herbert's 1965 Dune. And once you dig into it, if you're a sci-fi junkie like I am, once you dig into it, you're done, because there are five books following this, and they are just ridiculously long. I think we're talking 800-900 pages each, something like that. So yeah, it's paralyzing as far as literature consumption. But once you dive into that world, you're stuck. All the books are great; they're fantastic. The way that the series carries on over millennia really is really, really high concept science fiction. Really great stuff. Obviously, groundbreaking. Inspired movies, you know, music, everything. Highly recommended if people haven't seen it, or, you know, read it already. We're not talking about the movie here. I know a lot of people have seen the David Lynch joint, Tangerine Dream. Great stuff. I enjoyed it. It was fun, but it was not what the novel was. Really worth the time and effort invested getting through that whole series, the first book especially. In my second tap, I'll go with a joint by Douglas Adams. I think I'm going to do both of these books in the series by him. It's called the first one is called Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency.
Interesting.
It's awesome. And I mean, if anybody has read the Hitchhiker's Guide stuff and liked it, this stuff is right in that same wheelhouse, but I think funnier. And I think more clever. And I also, it's sci-fi, you know what I mean? And it's fantasy, but it's coming from a very different place. I love it.
What's the dude's last name?
Douglas Adams.
Dirk Gently.
Yeah.
Cumberbuck.
I've read both books, actually. They are quite good. You're right, Tiny.
Yeah, they're fantastic, aren't they?
I believe the BBC made a TV series based on those books, although I've never watched it.
Yeah, that could be true. I know there's a radio serial for... one of them, Long Dark Tea Time of the Soul, I think, which is the second in the series of two books with that character.
Right.
But both just awesome. Real quick reads too. Maybe they're 300 pages, something in that neighborhood. But quick reading and just so clever. Very very British sort of humor, but that's a good thing in this case. You know, kind of I don't know. Yeah, British humor. Again, if anybody has read or seen or been engaged in the Hitchhiker's Guide stuff at all and liked it, try this. You might like it even better. I did.
Cool. You're always bringing the novel love, book love.
Heck yeah.
All right. So looks like I'm the last one here. I'm going to go with two music picks.
Once a Four Loco kitty.
You better not give any Four Loco to my cat. All right, so the first one I'm going to talk about is Deltron 3030. You guys familiar?
Oh, fucking word, the new album?
New album.
Come on, hit me.
Event 2 came out a couple weeks ago. Yep. And if you aren't familiar with Deltron 3030, you got to check it out. Yeah. Yeah, it's fucking awesome. So Deltron 3030 consists of course, Del the Funky Homo Sapien, Dan the Automator, and Kid Koala. And their first album was just called Deltron 3030, and it came out in 2000.
Yep.
And Event 2 was just released at the end of September of this year. So I definitely recommend checking that out if you're familiar with Deltron. If you're not, man, this is...
You know Del if you listen to the fucking Gorillaz.
Yeah, for those who want to see what this this... duo is capable of, listening to some of that Gorilla stuff.
Yeah.
The song Clean Eastwood, Dell's the one who does the rapping in it.
Yeah.
There you go.
And he has, I always forget the name of it, but like track 4 on that Gorilla record is like perfect.
So this album just came out, and I'm just going to play a little bit for you. I'll let it speak for itself. If you're not even a fan of hip-hop, like this may be right in your wheelhouse. Yeah. Because the first Deltron 3030 album, I think, is probably up there in my top 5, if not top 2, for hip-hop albums of all time. It's that fucking good.
Yeah.
And this one, from what I've heard, I haven't given it as much time as I would have liked, but from what I've heard, it's real fucking good. You have something to add, Raven Shadow?
If you like comics, if you're a fan of Transmetropolitan, the first Deltron 3030 album is like a hip-hop take on a transmet world.
Really? Yeah. That sounds pretty good.
Yeah, I could see that. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Dystopian society, you know, futuristic.
Yeah.
All right, so let me go ahead and play. This is Talent Supersedes. Just play a little bit of this jam here.
Were considered sentient beings, we extended the regions. Powerful century, we deploy our infantry. Landing on the planet, switch chaos to simplicity. The galactic civil war made us feel like whores, wondering what we lived life for. I was trying to eliminate the Admiral Deltron, well versed historian. I have no known weak spot. I have a shield and protection. A group of tribes that are loosely connected through the primary language of banging. Establish a foothold, but barely maintain it. Part of the overall alliance with the cartel. Right before the central reactor started to melt, I don't bargain with no. But I'm Deltron, I'm rendezvous with diplomats with laser gas and bombs. Tell a super scene when I'll be at war with speed.
Tell a super scene when I'll be at war with speed. So there's a little bit of the new Deltron 3030. You should totally check this out because it's really fucking good.
Sold.
All right,
yeah,
next.
Sounds fun. I like it.
And it's great to hear a rapper who isn't slurring his words and... You know what I mean? No, I'm serious. I mean, these days...
Are you talking about me?
Full Loco is a hell of a beverage.
A hell of a drug.
I'm a problem.
So is Purple Drank, apparently.
I'm a problem solver.
So then... I'm going to go sort of the other end of the spectrum here for my second double tap.
Yeah.
And they don't have...
Deltron 1-1?
No.
Judy Garland.
I've looked at clouds from both sides now.
They don't have anything new out that I'm going to, you know, talk about right now. But one of my favorite metal bands, you know, because I do love the metal, even though, you know, hang out with the Deadites and do electronic music with these guys. But I'm very much a metalhead at heart, and I'm going to go ahead and double tap the band Opeth. If you guys aren't familiar with Opeth, you should be, because this is definitely one of the better metal bands out there. They've sort of... They started out as purely like black metal, and now they've sort of twisted into something very different. Now they're almost like a progressive 70s metal band. There's a lot of different influences in there, but I'm going to play this one. This track I'm going to play just gets right to the point. This is off their album from 2008 called Watershed, and the name of this track is The Lotus Eater, and it gives you a pretty good idea of what they're all about. So here is a little bit of Opeth.
Stop humming, David Chan.
Hey.
You get to see a little bit of the range of Opeth. They're sort of all over the map, but they're a really fucking good band, and I highly recommend you checking them out if you haven't already. What'd you think of that, Raven Shadow?
Oh, it's fucking sweet.
Sweet. Nobody says that anymore.
I first fucking said it. Rewind it. Sweet. Sweet as a biscuit.
As a biscuit?
Yeah.
Put the biscuit in the basket?
Yeah, whatever you, I don't care what you fucking do, but why don't you turn that just track on and... Vibe.
Just vibe on it. I knew you were going there. Yeah.
Go on the treadmill. Why don't you go uphill?
All right. Well, this episode's winding down. So
yeah,
we didn't kill Sir Isaac, and he... You know what?
Giovanni, please let me out of this hole.
You know what? I have to.
Hey, put the lotion on the skin.
I have to commend Sir Isaac. He projects much better than any of you fools on the mic.
Hey,
you're welcome.
Hey,
hey yourself.
Maybe you should acquire a stupid British accent, Raven Shadow.
Oh, governor. Look, 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 look here.
See? What?
That sounds so fake.
Hi. Look, look, look,
look, look. Look, look. Make a look at high.
Yeah, English accent by Jambie.
By Wyclef.
I think the phrase you're looking for is by cracky.
Cracky?
That's the name of MonsterZero and Giovanni's porno.
Oh,
oh,
boy. Oh, I thought it was God Save the Queen.
Let's go to commercial.
No, no, it's like the end of the show.
You ready for meatball spaghetti?
I was going to play a song. I can't find it right away.
It's on.
There we go.
Are we?
Let this play it out. You know the song, Raven Shadow, right?
Oh, shit, yeah. Oh, right.
I'm looking down the hole, you're looking up at me. You're cold and tired, that is easy to see.
The hole must be gaping.
Nice. Your membrane will be soft and smooth, and your heart will be mine. It rubs the lotion on its skin.
My joint.
All right, I don't want to play too much. I don't want to get sued by the Greenskeepers.
Oh, fuck those guys.
Good Boston boys, though.
Fuck them in the ear.
Fuck them in the ear?
Yeah.
Jesus, man.
Fuck them in the other ear.
Yeah.
All right.
No more Four Loko for you.
Yeah. Right. So how did the Four Loko experience go?
Nice. Nice.
Let's fucking play it back.
You didn't finish it?
Not yet.
Jesus, you're a lightweight. Did you finish yours?
Yeah, I'm done. Yeah, but that.
You got a Coca-Cola. Did you even open it?
No, I didn't.
This one.
I don't drink. I don't like to drink Coke when I do the show. I'll drink this later. Yeah. Look at this.
Just like to have it in front of you. It's comforting.
You need to keep that here. I need at least one, unless you want it. I need one, at least one for the studio. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm done.
We got the Trooper Ale up there, so we need a Four Loko. So
driving home's gonna be so exciting.
As an aside, I think I would have been okay with like 2.5 Loco.
I say a good driver is a relaxed driver. That's what
four
I
was
say.
Just a little too much for you.
Yeah. Yeah. Just my belly, you know.
Yeah. Well, there is an FDA warning about it.
Yeah.
Is Obby's open still?
Yeah. Between this and the Irish coffee, I'm feeling.
Let's
a
get
little...
breakfast.
Denny's, IHOP.
Yeah, we should.
I got a meeting at 8 a.m. Yeah,
with who?
With. The whole company, actually. It sucks. It's at the
with the debt? Oh, I'm still, not there in there.
We're still rolling.
That's so exciting.
You just outed yourself. You're like outing everyone else.
Yeah, I think the Ryan Gosling thing outed me fine.
What's the movie next week?
Grab us.
Why don't we grab some breakfast?
Grab us.
Ryan Gosling was ruined for me a little bit.
Why?
Because somebody said that he looked like Tiny.
A little bit.
Yeah. You know what's? Know what I
Although
think is funny about
not that handsome.
You know what I think is how our fans, what our fans think of Tiny. First off, they think it was good to put the only halfway decent looking guy in a mask, and now they want to take the only one that has a good radio voice and have him talking to vocoder all the time.
You're welcome.
Tiny's the only one with a good radio voice.
I have the worst radio. I am the worst radio voice.
You sound like mean Christopher Walken. It's good.
All right. Well, that's going to do it. Raven Shadow, have any last thoughts?
So many, but I'm going to save them.
Well, how was the Four Loko? You approve? Are you going to drink it again?
Yeah, no. I'm going to be up all night and probably the next day.
4 days. That's what the four stands
yeah,
for.
Yeah, I'm going to take some lorazepam and probably smoke a bowl to really... some turpentine to really like take me down. And I can really. Who has pancakes? Really? Am I the only one?
I don't have them. I like them.
You must have some Bisquick in the back.
No. Put the Bisquick in the basket.
All right, let's go to commercial.
It's fucking over. It's done. Ah! The show is over.
It was good.
All right.
All right. See you guys.
Senor Isaac didn't call in.
Oh, fuck. We didn't do any. Oh, my God. I'm such a dick.
Where did voicemails go?
I'm such a dick.
All right. Rapid fire.
We get so caught up. We usually do it before the double tap. Yeah. No, we did. Thank you for reminding me. I don't know how you knew, but.
Well, that son of a bitch better call in. I'll pay him to read those VOD comics.
Because he didn't finish his Four Loko.
That's right. All right. So here's Senor Isaac did call in.
Ooh.
So let's cut to this real quick.
Countdown to infinite cancellation.
Goodbye, vibe.
Hola, amigos. This is Senor Isaac with the review of Vibe issue number 6. Now, in the last issue, Vibe was tossed into a prison run by Argus. So to get him out, his brother Dante tracks down Argus's assistant director, Dale Gunn, and tells him that if he doesn't help him get Vibe out of prison, he'll tell everybody all about Argus. And this would be a terrible thing to do, because Argus is such a super secret organization that the only way you can identify them in public is by spotting their huge logo on the sides of all their cars, all their helicopters, all along the walls of their enormous building in the middle of Detroit, and on the uniforms of their hundreds and hundreds of employees. They're that secret. So Dante and Gon sneak into Argus headquarters and locate Vibe. But during the breakout, one of Argus's soldiers shoots Dante right in the chest. Miraculously, Dante not only doesn't die, but continues to walk and talk. Now, I don't know about you, amigos, but I only know one other person who can take a huge load to the chest and survive. And this comic would have been very different if Vibe's brother had turned out to be Sasha Gray.
There you go, there
sadly,
you go.
That's not the case. Dante only leaves because this comic relies on the cheapest of shock tactics to get people to read it. And that's not even the cheapest tactic in this issue. After Dante gets shot, Vibe's powers go a little crazy, which was really convenient for the writer. A tear is created in the fabric of reality, and what do you know? Vibe's brother Armando, whom we've been told since issue number 1 was dead, suddenly shows up alive and well and working as a supervillain named Rupture. Now, in my mind, there is nothing worse than being told something over and over again only to find out it's a massive lie. And on an unrelated note, please say hi to my friend, British supervillain Sir Isaac, for me.
Back at you, buddy.
Anyway, that's it for issue number 6. Join me next week when I review issue number 7 in Countdown to Infinite Cancellation.
Now, Isaac, I have to say, there were some rumors that Senor Isaac and Sir Isaac were actually the same person.
That's insane. I'm standing right here, and you just played a message of
him. Well, that's what I'm saying. I mean,
exactly.
Proof's in the pudding, right?
We don't even sound alike. Come on.
I didn't agree with them, but I'm just saying what people were saying. So,
pudding.
So there we have it. Thank you to Senor Isaac for calling in the Vibe number 6. I can't even keep track. DC can't even keep track.
It's not worth keeping track.
No. We have one more message. This is a very... What? What are you laughing at?
I'm the only one that knows that the dude Dale they were talking about was the black guy from the Justice League Detroit.
You're the only one in the world?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
You sound so drunk.
He was...
I'm the only one that knows. Oh, the guy Leo is talking about.
Thanks for the shout-out, guys.
Thank you.
Dale was like the Tyrese of the JLA Detroit.
Thanks, fellas.
Nice.
It's true.
You're the only fucking person in the world that knows that.
I think so. Raise your hand.
I'll believe that.
You're talking to the mic. We're still on there.
Are we?
You're fucking it. Hammered. Drifting. You're not, you're not driving home.
When?
You're hammered.
I'm fine.
He had 6.5 locos.
Treat. He's literally talking into the Four Loko can instead of the microphone now.
Hello.
All right. Well,
He's bombed Aleo.
We have one more voicemail.
One time.
I think this is might be for you. I think it said for Raven Shadow. So let's check this out.
Hi there. This is Joe Camel. And I just wanted to send some words of support to Michael Raven Shadow. Excuse me. First off, Michael, don't listen to those other guys. No. They're just jealous that when you put something in your mouth and suck on it, it doesn't have a foreskin. And,
see?
Yeah. Wow. You know how they keep saying that you're going to die from cancer if you don't quit? They don't know that. You could die from all kinds of random things like emphysema, black lung. You could even die on the operating table during a routine tracheotomy. So, that hurt. So keep on smoking. And the next time somebody tells you to give up, just remember, winners never quit.
Right.
And quitters never get their own portable oxygen tank.
See? So,
I gotta go. Keep it up, buddy.
Thanks,
bro. Cut off there at the end.
Yeah, what happened? He probably died.
That bad connection.
What do you think of that?
Nah, he's right.
You're going to be like that in like 2 days.
It's a matter of time, man. You know what I mean?
I am proud of you, though. You didn't go out for a cigarette smoke tonight.
Nope. I did.
Wow.
You did?
I did. That was like a ninja. Yeah.
Did you use love grenade?
No, man. I was all natural. I wore Dynamo's jacket.
Oh. You know?
So all that D&D urine from the VFW hall.
D&D is different where
and it's the Masonic temple.
Yeah, whatever it was. Here's the thing, though. Oh, you know, I know smoking
Remember
is
children.
A disgusting habit, but Dynamo does do roll tabletop gaming.
Roll tabletop gaming?
Yeah.
You used to do tabletop gaming too, sir.
Yeah, but then I turned 15.
Smoking is bad, but Dynamo does role playing.
But maybe in that Masonic home, you pull out.
An adult that does role playing.
We need a beat behind that, I think.
What was that?
Baby. Animal does role playing. Animal does role playing. Role playing. Role playing.
Yo. Where I game, there's a lot of manage, but smoking it does double damage.
No.
What are
you
doing?
You said crap around my mother, so here, you can have this one too.
Everyone says Raven Shadow's full of shit, but smoking is a critical hit.
Are we going to get fucking endorsed by Little Debbie's? Seriously.
Wait, why are there Little Debbie's in the studio right now?
Raven Time Shadow out. Again. Raven is, Shadow. Look, he's...
I've had so many Little Debbie's in my mouth, I'm going to be on a list.
Dynamo has like 3 in his mouth right now. Jesus
Wait,
fucking
is
Christ,
Raven
dude.
Shadow still off the cigarettes?
Yes.
Well, then what's wrong with you?
So many things. All right, listen. All right, maybe when you're tabletop gaming...
The problem is you're still on the Dynamo.
We're way over time here, guys.
Yeah, right. We are.
We'll see you next week.
That's so unlocked this show.
But you know what's going to happen.
What?
She's going to bum one off you, and you're going to be responsible for her to start smoking again.
And you're going to be responsible for him losing his feet.
Motherfucker, I met you guys in the smoking section of fucking Danny's.
Yeah, because we had no 15. Choice. Yeah,
like...
Speaking of 15.
No fucking surprises.
When we were
15, surprises.
You were still role-playing.
Yeah, like, I'm not... You know what I mean? Like, why don't you pull some fucking brute out your bag of holding and give me a +5 for a fucking shower of speed stick, motherfucker? You know what I'm saying? Like,
he's making fun of us, but when we were going to game, first one that was like, I'll play was Raven Shadow.
Yeah, because you said I could be booking Boost of Gold.
No, this was recently.
Yeah, last week.
I want to play.
You can't have two of those.
I'm not.
Oh, Jesus.
No,
he's going to
have three.
No, Jesus Christ.
If you have diabetes, don't eat the sugar treaties.
Or you lose both your feeties.
There you go. This has been a public service announcement, Isaac, from where?
Trick or treat radio, bitch.
There you go.
See Ryan Gosling, I beat my meaties.
All right. Tiny, any last things before we go?
No, let's get the fuck out of here.
All right, Dynamo.
Remember, phone
insulin, he'll be needy.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit. All right, well, thanks for tuning in to episode 69.
Woo. We're sorry.
Yeah, we're very sorry for this episode, everyone.
Well, I'm not.
And we will see you again next week on episode 70.
Ooh.
All right, folks. See you later.
I don't think we can't be that far over time. We start at 8:30.